On the flip side, when you're up 3-1, can you deal the final blow? You've been quicker and more resolute, and big numbers have come from lesser knowns. Can your late winter move pay off on the eve of summer? Your mantra is, do it the right way. And you'll try to prove once again it's not who you are, but how you play that matters most. Lakers Pistons in the NBA Finals, tonight, Game 5. Welcome to the Palace of Auburn Hills outside Detroit. Will a third championship banner hang from the rafters after these NBA Finals? The Bad Boys from the two championship teams, the coach, Chuck Daly, Bill Laimbeer is here tonight. John Sally is here tonight. So is Rick Mahorn. Karl Malone would have made a great Bad Boy, but he has a bad knee and is not in uniform and gets embraced just moments ago by Piston coach Larry Brown. And we are set right now for Game 5 of the NBA Finals. The Los Angeles Lakers taking on the Detroit Pistons. I'm Al Michaels with Doc Rivers. Michelle Tafoya and Stuart Scott will work the sidelines. Can the Pistons pull off one of the great upsets in NBA Finals history? Right now they're on the verge of that. The Lakers are just trying to take the series back to L.A. for a sixth game on Thursday and, if necessary, a seventh game on Sunday. Oft times when there's an upset in the making, there's a lot of mystery. There's a lot of luck involved. Not so here. It's simple. The Pistons have just played better, including in the second game when the Lakers needed a miracle to pull out a victory. In fact, the Lakers are the lucky ones. They're lucky they haven't been swept. Doc, Phil Jackson first, the Laker coach. We talked to him earlier. What can a guy who's never been in this situation with a veteran team, down 3-1, what can he do? What will he do?
Well, I think the first thing he has to do is make his players believe. He has to tell them that the solution is in the locker room. It's not about changes. What we do, we have to do it better. More importantly, he has to let them know that if they win this game, the rest of the playoffs are at home. But more importantly, he has to get more than just Shaquille O'Neal and Kobe Bryant playing. He needs one more guy. I don't know who that guy will be, but he has to get one more guy to help the cause.
They're the only guys in double figures for the Lakers in each of the four games. Now there's Larry Brown. We both know him very well. He's a fretter. He doesn't want to think ahead. He's in the moment. Can he keep his team in the moment?
Yeah, he has to. He has to stay in it now. He has to get his team to understand if you lose this game, this is your last game at home for the rest of the season. Stay in it now, and you'll win the game.
Kind of funny. Brown staying in the moment. Phil Jackson is a guy who loves to stay in the moment, but he's got to be thinking about Thursday.
Yes.
Getting there anyway. Right now, to the public address announcer, our man, Mason.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you remain standing as we now honor America with the singing of the national anthem being performed tonight by Detroit's own international recording icon, the Queen of Soul, Miss Aretha Franklin.
See my lonesome. 22,000 pair of Thunder Sticks saluting that rendition. Get the game underway. Look at the starting lineups after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
You're wrong.
You're wrong.
You're wrong.
You know you're wrong, right?
Yeah.
Hearts or puppies?
Hearts and puppies.
She replied to my email yet?
Oh.
How about now?
Oh.
How about these?
How about these?
Ballet?
Works every time.
Sounds good, right? Ballet?
Life's better with the butterfly. Come see all the ways you can get more done at MSN.com.
This fall, ABC asked, what would happen if we took two moms and made them swap lives?
Oh my God, this is a big challenge.
Two mothers from different backgrounds.
I needed to do it to grow and become a bigger person.
With completely different values.
My husband's never been without me. This will be a rude awakening for him.
We'll swap homes, families, and lifestyles.
Vegetarian meals for everybody.
Trying to control my anger. Such a stupid moron.
Happy together.
Wife Swap, Wednesdays this fall on ABC.
There's never been a better time to get into a Jeep brand 4x4, like Jeep Liberty Sport. Right now, qualified lessees can get one for just $239 a month and only $999 due at signing. The ever-capable Liberty with four-wheel drive, power windows, locks, and air conditioning for just $239 a month. But get in today, because this incredible offer ends June 30th. The best values in America are at your Jeep dealer during June bonus days.
It's a hurricane warning, folks. Category 5, severe coastal flooding and structure.
Grab whatever you can. Meet me back here.
Vitamins.
Hey, baby doll.
No. We're gonna die.
We are lost.
You keep complaining.
I'm losing faith in your sense of direction.
Yeah. We're on our way. Who's there?
Six girls?
Six girls.
Does one of them know where we are?
Oh.
Oh, great.
Break glass in case of adventure.
Now, we're in a Nissan Armada. Everyone can roll with us.
We're going to the party now.
Can I please drive now?
I'd love to drive.
Presenting the full-size Nissan Armada.
Time and temperature from Commerce Bank.
Getting started under pressure. The ones that bring it, the ones that test you. When we moving the rock, when we making a shot,
make magic.
With only 1 o'clock, and the feeling's irresistible when we all shine.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started.
Of Auburn Hills already rocking. It will throughout the evening as we get set to take a look at the Bud Light starting lineups for you. And with Malone out, a change for the Lakers up front. And Devin George, Medvedenko replaces Malone, O'Neal in the middle, Prince, and the two Wallaces up front for Detroit. The guards for the Lakers, Gary Payton and Kobe Bryant. For Detroit, Chauncey Billups right now, a primary candidate for MVP, and Richard Hamilton. And we go to Michelle.
All right, well, with Karl Malone out, Phil Jackson said before the game, Al, that Slava Medvedenko, quote, has a game that he can bring to this matchup with Rasheed Wallace. He also said that Medvedenko is a far better player than what he's shown in this series so far. But Phil also said he has told every one of his players to be ready to play tonight as he plans to throw everything he has at Detroit. And speaking of Detroit, let's go over to Stuart Scott.
Michelle, 14 years after winning their last title, almost every Piston player to a man said the biggest challenge is focusing on one game without thinking about what happens when they win that game. Chauncey Billups told me, my only fear is that we want it so bad that we come out and start individually trying to do too much. Nothing selfish, he said. No agendas, just wanting it so bad, Al, and being that close.
Right now, Jack Nicholson is here to lend support to his beloved Lakers. Jack comes to town for the first time in the middle three games. Lakers trying to go home and take Detroit with them. In each of the four games in this series, we've had a jump ball violation to start the game. The only jump ball the Lakers have won was the one in overtime in game two, the most important. So we get set to go. Tonight's telecast available in high definition and Spanish on ESPN Deportes. Joey Crawford, who will work the game with Bernie Fryer and Bennett Salvador to put the ball in the air. O'Neal at the ready. Ben Wallace jumping for Detroit. Wallace is 6'9", gives away about 3.5 inches, and that time, well, legal jump ball. And the Lakers get it. That means they will start the fourth quarter with a possession.
And if you're a Laker fan, every sign is important. I mean, that every possession is important is why Shaq didn't try to steal the ball.
And Slava Medvedenko, who got the ball from O'Neal, dropped it on the baseline after Shaq was doubled and then almost tripled as Malone takes a seat on the bench. Well, it's a three-second violation.
Yeah, and the key will be with Slava Medvedenko is where they can space him out, because what the Pistons are doing when he's in the game, they're using his guy to double-team Shaquille O'Neal, not only with the ball, but without the ball.
Heavy pressure by George Medvedenko is making his first start since March 10th, over 3 months.
And one change you see early in this game is Kobe Bryant is starting the game out, guarding Chauncey Billups, and that leads to an early foul. Now, what did you see there, Al, right away? The difference in this series, in my opinion, is that the Lakers have taken a ton of jump shots, and the Pistons keep attacking the basket. Right there, Chauncey Billups gets to the basket, and now he gets to the foul line.
So Kobe Bryant picks up his first personal 35 seconds into the game. The Lakers never let in game three here last Thursday. Had the lead from time to time in the fourth game on Sunday. So Detroit up 2-0 at the outset, and Bryant with a foul. Gary Payton is guarded by Billups. George has Hamilton on him. Here's Medvedenko. He's free and hits from 19 feet.
And that is significant. Every shot he can make makes Rasheed Wallace pay more attention to him. That one shot does nothing, but if he can make a couple of them, it will.
Payton is there. Got his hand on it, out of bounds. It'll be inbounded with 11 seconds on the timer by Detroit.
I like this move by the Lakers for a couple of reasons. One, I do think Gary Payton has the ability to stay with Rip Hamilton. Two, Kobe Bryant has a bigger body to guard Billups.
French is free from outside. In and out. Payton gets his first rebound. Pushes it up the floor. Medvedenko is free again and hits. So the Lakers, who had O'Neal and Bryant as the only guy in double figures in every game, have another guy now with 4 points in the first minute and a half.
Well, the one thing we know about Slava Medvedenko, he's going to give himself a chance. I mean, he is not an unwilling shooter.
Over Medvedenko, and Wallace drops one in.
That's where they miss Karl Malone. Karl Malone's ability to push Wallace off the block will be missed this evening.
Bryant to O'Neal. Shaq misses his first shot of the night after scoring 36 with 20 rebounds and a tremendous performance the other night that was wasted. And Billups has it knocked away, stolen by the Lakers. Medvedenko again. Can he make it three in a row? Yes, he can. So Slava Medvedenko replacing Malone. You know he can give him the offense that Malone can't. And Doc, as you pointed out, the big question is against Rasheed Wallace.
Yeah, and the key for Rasheed Wallace is will he stay on the post? He has a habit of popping out off the block. That's where the Lakers would love to see him.
Medvedenko tried to front him. Now he gets behind him. And as Wallace works the ball outside, there's a foul here on the Lakers on Devin George.
Yeah, and you notice that third one, Rasheed Wallace came at him. Now, this is the third team foul already for the Lakers, and this is what they don't want, is to get the silly fouls, Al. That's where they've been hurt so far.
The other night, the Lakers committed 36 fouls as O'Neal gets it over to Bryant. So the Lakers coming out tenaciously on defense Here's Medvedenko again. This time he's going to dump it into O'Neal, and O'Neal's going to softly put it over the rim to make it 8-4 Lakers.
But Al, you already saw the difference. With Medvedenko making shots, when he caught it that time, Rasheed Wallace ran out to him. That allowed him to drop the ball in the shot.
French guarded by George. Works off a Rasheed Wallace screen. Can't get it to drop, but Rasheed is there. Puts it up. Nothing happening. And O'Neal quickly gets it ahead to Bryant. Kobe's first effort is good, and the Lakers lead by a half dozen. 3.5 into the game, and the Lakers, at least at the outset, come out as a team that knows exactly what's at stake tonight.
And they're doing two things. Number one, they're playing defense. And by playing defense, that's allowing them to get in the open court.
And underneath, going down hard and drawing that response from the crowd is the angular and very thin Tayshaun Prince. Foul is on O'Neal.
That's the first flop flagrant I've seen. You know, usually they're just flops, and he was hit hard. But watch Tayshaun Prince. He's going to lay down there for a minute to see if he could draw the flagrant foul. And when he noticed that there was not another whistle, he kind of turned around and popped right back up.
Prince hasn't made a free throw in this series. He's now 0-for-4 in this series. Lakers fouling the Pistons at, for them, an alarming rate. And tonight already three, including one each on Bryant and O'Neal.
And those are huge, not only because they're free fouls, but because of Bryant and O'Neal. The one thing Phil Jackson needs them to be is aggressive. And when you get those early fouls, you become passive.
Anybody who follows the NBA knows if you get two early fouls, the coach almost compelled to put you on the bench. Bryant fakes Prince out, and with Hamilton in his face, can't get that to go. And a whistle underneath, and Bernie Fryer is going to call a loose ball foul here on O'Neal. And so that's two already on Shaquille O'Neal, 4 minutes and 2 seconds into the game.
Exactly what the Lakers didn't want. Two fouls on O'Neal. More importantly, 14 fouls. Now, for the rest of this quarter, they are in the penalty.
And in this situation, Jackson, of course, minus Malone, has to leave him in. And then Wallace drives for the hoop, and Ben gets the gong from the guys upstairs as he drops one in to make it 10-7.
Well, Ben Wallace knew that Shaq couldn't get in his way because of the two fouls.
Here's Medvedenko again. O'Neal trying to tip it up. Out of bounds it goes. Lakers will have it. See, O'Neal giving a piece of his mind to Bennett Salvador on the last foul.
Yeah, what they're saying is you called the over the back on Shaq. Shaq felt like the Detroit Pistons just went over the back on him.
What a play. As O'Neal got it, gave it back to Devin George. He's able to get under the basket and face it and put it in. 12-7.
Well, the one change already by the Lakers offensively is that they're trying to get to the bucket tonight themselves.
And they're taking far too many jump shots and hitting very few three-pointers to this point. Cross-court, Prince moves in for about a 12-footer that hits the side of the backboard. O'Neal gets the rebound. L.A. up by 5. Medvedenko to Shaq. Medvedenko again. And that time, his worst effort of the night. So he starts out hot. Then he hits the rim on one, and that one barely grazed it.
And the key for him is that he has to keep shooting.
Hamilton. And knocked away by Payton. So Gary Payton got a hand in. Payton, who's been eaten up in this series by Billups, makes a good defensive play for the steal.
I gotta tell you, I like Payton's look tonight.
Bryant goes underneath, loses the ball, no foul is called, and it winds up in Medvedenko's hands for the basket.
This is the most engaged that I've seen Gary Payton in a long time. That doesn't mean he's going to play well, but he is engaged into this game.
Medvedenko in this series had 8 points total coming in to tonight's game. He is 8 at the outset. 14-7 Lakers.
For Kumal and Sangha, the jungle was the only home they'd ever known. Until the day.
What are you doing here?
They were taken from their family. On June 25th, experience their incredible journey home.
They're just trying to find their way back.
Two Brothers, rated PG, starts June 25th.
Very nice.
Like all light beers, it's low in carbs. Unlike any other light beer, it's got the great taste of Bud Light. What we have here is a failure to compromise. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here.
Start the car.
Horsepower V6, traction control, and sliding rear seats. Chevy Malibu Max, an American revolution.
All right, Tim, 80,000 all in. Okay, all right, forget about that. I was just kidding. 72.5. Say no more. Moonroof, extended warranty. Stop me at any time. Titanium wheels package. After that, I mean, if you're cutting into my, which you don't care about, I got nothing else, Tim. Done.
Did you know you were going 65? Okay, 55.
No matter how they toss the dice, it had to be the only one for me is you and you for me. So happy together.
The NBA Finals on ABC, brought to you by Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here. The new Chevrolets, 10 new cars and trucks in 20 months, an American revolution. American Express, the official card of high flyers. And Two Brothers. On June 25th, join two Tiger Cubs on their unforgettable journey home.
Back in Auburn Hills, Michigan, Slava Medvedenko has already scored 8 points. Amazingly, Kobe and Shaq, as we mentioned before, the only Lakers in double figures in four consecutive games. How unusual is that? Well, this league's been around 58 years. That's 42,000-plus regular season games, about 3,000 playoff games. It's never happened. Never.
That's an unbelievable number.
Shaq comes out of the game here, and from the corner, it is Tayshaun Prince. For a long two. So O'Neal with two fouls out of the game. They have Brian Took in the game. Here's Kobe now. Kobe draws a crowd.
Boy, he sure does.
Yeah, what else is new? Medvedenko trying to get into double figures, and Medvedenko gets fouled as he works the baseline, and that will be the first foul, and that's Rasheed Wallace. Now, Wallace has been in foul trouble in this series. In the first three games, he barely played in any of the second quarters. And then the other night, he stayed out of foul trouble and had a great night.
Yeah, and that was why he had a great night, because he was allowed to play the whole game.
Cook missing.
See, that's the one thing Cook can do. Now, you're wondering why Phil Jackson takes Shaq out. Well, he has two fouls. That's number one. I think the other reason is they have a 5-3-point lead, and he's going to look at the scoreboard and watch it. And as long as the Lakers have a lead or even get down just a little bit, he can afford to sit Shaq.
That was Rasheed Wallace, and that's Bryant. Ball comes out to Devin George. Bryant again, and Bryant gets pushed by Chauncey Billups. I mentioned the other night, the Lakers had 35 personal fouls in the last game. The Pistons, 20. That was the largest difference between the number of fouls for two teams in any game in the 58-year history of the NBA Finals. We'll beat a lot of them at the end, but still, it's been the story of the series.
Yeah, it really has been. And the reason it's such a big story, Al, is because the Lakers led the league in free throws.
Cook made a terrible pass, but it came back to Bryant. And then the call is against the Lakers.
You know, that's why you don't play rookies. Honestly. And I hate to be so harsh. But first, the pass. I mean, you're in the world championship game that you can be eliminated. You get on the floor and you throw a no-look pass to another big. I mean, that's number one. And then to commit the foul after that. You know, Phil Jackson is thinking, that's probably why I don't play young guys in finals.
Phil's also thinking, how bizarre is this? I've got four Hall of Famers and a fifth seed to start the season. I'm in an elimination game, and I have to have Cook in the game early. I have to have Medvedenko in the game early. I've got Malone in street clothes and Shaq with two fouls.
Yeah, and that's a tough situation. But one of the things Phil Jackson talked about early in the year is how much he enjoyed working with Cook and Luke Walton. And he thought that they both would be excellent players. I don't know if he knew that he would lead them this early.
Six straight points for Detroit. 7-point lead is now one. Bryant guarded by Prince. Shoots over him. Doesn't drop. Big Ben high for the rebound. Now the Pistons can assume the lead here. Phillips puts it on his hip. Goes all the way. That's the bounce. So Shaq goes to the bench, and the Pistons are on an 8-0 run.
And that's not a coincidence. They're struggling scoring on one end, and the Pistons are attacking the basket on the other end because they know there's no shot blocker.
Shaq has been on the bench in this series 20 minutes. In those 20 minutes, the Pistons have outscored the Lakers 40-19. Jackson takes a timeout. Pistons have the lead.
Celebrated with a bell. And every day when this bell rings, it's a symbol of our pledge to serve the investor with new standards, new leadership, and a renewed commitment to being the best market on earth. It's your market, and there's only one trade that really matters here. Yours. The New York Stock Exchange.
50 First Dates, now on DVD.
Monday, you can fall apart.
I like you, and you like me, most days.
50 First Dates. Get it today on DVD.
When it comes to fresh, no one does it like Subway. Behold our line of delicious low-fat sandwiches, made fresh with under 6 pounds of fat. Pile on fresh veggies, and don't forget the fresh baked bread, because this is Subway, and this is how you eat fresh. Subway. Eat fresh.
I love my wife. She's a great mother. She finds time to work, take care of me, the kids, the house. But sometimes I do wonder what it would be like to trade her in.
Wife Swap, ABC Wednesdays this fall.
Our club has been one of the most difficult clubs to project how they're going to play of any team I've ever coached this particular year. So much of it depends upon Shaquille. He expanded himself so much the other night. We wasted one of the great games that we saw him play in this playoffs. It's going to depend upon him. Right now, I think we're feeling really pretty good about it. Kobe's guaranteed the fact that we're going to win. That in itself says something about it, and I like the mental attitude of the ball club.
He was talking about Shaq and wasting that performance, and they wasted their lead here. 8-0 run. In a little over a minute and a half, but Shaq was on the bench. Jimsy's back in.
Yeah, and I thought that what Phil was doing was right. He was going to wait, look at the score. Now they're down. He puts Shaq back in. I think this is a huge key part of the game right now for Detroit. They have Shaq in foul trouble. They have the Pistons. They have the Lakers in penalty. They must keep attacking this basket.
And that was Devin George with the slam to make it 16-15. Meanwhile, Kobe Bryant for the Lakers has started out cold again. Kobe 1-for-5, hitting only 38% from the field in this series. Prince all the way, drops it in.
See, they know that Shaq can't help. And if he does help, they're going to throw their bodies right into him. So it'll be interesting how Shaq handles this.
And that'll make Prince very effective as well. He loves that move. Goes to the lane and puts it in. Shaq misses, gets his own rebound, and stuffs it back in.
Even a passive Shaq is aggressive. Even a passive Shaq is effective. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. And a passive Shaq who knows his season could be over. And Shaquille with two early fouls. Payton guarding Hamilton. It puts it in over Gary to make it 19-18. Lead Seesaw.
That's the one area where I think Rip Hamilton is going to have to take advantage of Gary Payton, and that's his size.
Payton losing it. Stolen by Wallace. He's out in front all alone. 21-18 on the steal by Big Ben. Feeding O'Neal again. Medvedenko can't get it to drop. Rebound to Phillips. Pistons running the floor. Score it. Hamilton. 23-18. Crowd roaring. 5-point lead coming down to 2 minutes to go in the period. Pistons 12-4 run here. Inside it comes. And the foul here. Foul is on Corliss Williamson.
And first the steal by Ben Wallace. I was really surprised no one tried to track him down and give him a foul. And then you saw Devin George at the bottom of your screen with an opportunity to get in spot and take a charge. And instead, he moved out of the way. Those are the little things that are really hurting this Laker team. And one of the things Larry Brown said is we want to run on the Lakers as much as possible.
That was a non-shooting foul. He started with 14 on the timer. And Kobe Bryant pulls one of his patented moves by driving through traffic to the hoop. 23-20. Luke Walton has come into the game. He provided the fuse that lit the Lakers in the second quarter in game two.
And right when Luke comes in, Corliss Williamson is in, and they're going to post him up.
O'Neal gets the rebound. Bryant, 4 points to this point. Payton will drive. Jump hook from the lane. Lakers cut it to one. Gary's first two of the night.
A drive by Kobe Bryant. A drive by Devin George. A drive by Gary Payton. This Laker team right now is playing differently than they played all series.
Have to. We work it out to Hamilton. Six on the timer. Williamson would have counted. He'll go to the line. You know, I was thinking, Doc, in this series, the four games, you have four quarters in an overtime period. There are only two sections that I can remember the Lakers dominating. One was the Walton part of game two, late in the first half, injecting the energy. The other was the overtime period. Apart from that, it's been either the Pistons or neutral. But the Lakers have had control of the pace and tempo so few minutes in the series.
Yeah, actually, this is the only time, as crazy as it sounds, it's a 24-22 lead by the Pistons, but this is the first up-tempo basketball that you've seen in this entire series. So if you're Phil Jackson, you're looking at the score, you know you're down, but you got to think he likes this tempo much better. There's more driving to the bucket, and there's more running in the game and open-court basketball. That's the way the Lakers actually want to play.
Williamson drops two. It's the most points scored by either team in the first quarter in this series, the 25 for Detroit. Bryant, Prince on him. Kobe in the lane, drives, gets fouled. Bryant draws the foul. The foul is a two-shot foul. The Pistons now have committed 14 fouls and the Lakers 6.
I mean, it's obvious, Al. I mean, it's obvious watching this Lakers team play tonight that Phil Jackson has told them, guys, I can't fight for you about fouls if you're going to keep launching jump shots. You have to get to the foul line. You have to drive the basketball. And eventually, if you drive, you will get to the foul line.
25-23, that's their first free throw of the night. Shelly Brown, Larry's wife, who is a lot more nervous than Larry, guarantee it.
I don't know.
Larry Heisen.
Larry didn't look too calm in that office before the game today.
But Larry's always
yeah, that's
Larry.
True. That is Larry.
25-24 Detroit. Eldon Campbell. Walton comes over to help. Way back outside to Hunter. Now Campbell. And Walton comes in there to provide the defense after he got by Shaq. Shaq has to be very careful with the two fouls. Now the Lakers can run it down.
You know what was interesting? Luke Walton, the rookie, was running down the floor yelling, one shot, one shot.
He's a smart rookie. He's in the jeans. With three on the timer, Bryant can't drop it. And that'll be the end of the first quarter. And there is still time. There is, well, 0.4 of a second. And you know what that means. But Derek Fisher certainly knows what it means.
And Kobe Bryant is really upset because he thought he had Tayshaun Prince up in the air and drew contact. Mm-hmm. And he really wants to know why that foul wasn't called.
They put 0.2 on the clock. Pistons will have to inbound from backcourt. O'Neal's going to come out. They're not going to take any chances here. Even with 0.6. That would be a horrible third foul.
Well, there's a lot of time. We know that with 0.6.
0.2 more than you need. Prince looking to fling it down the floor. Does down the baseline here. Hunter puts it up. And at least he got the rim. No foul call there. Bryant goes off the floor. Asking Bennett Salvatore if he's going to call any fouls when he's shooting tonight. Larry Brown working Joey Crawford. Detroit, good first quarter. Pistons leading the Lakers 25-24 in game five. You're watching the NBA Finals on ABC Sports Championship Television.
Next line, please, Jason.
F-O-D-P-C.
Good. Now the line below it.
D-P-L-T-C.
Now the bottom one.
Z-O-L. Doc, I can't see when you're doing that.
Oh, I'm
CFT.
Sorry.
Thanks, Mr. Kidd.
Richard, your car's being towed. What?
What? Oh.
Hey. It's my car.
He arrived as a tourist, but one man is standing between him and America.
Yes.
Tom Hanks, Catherine Zeta-Jones, from director Steven Spielberg. The Terminal, rated PG-13, starts Friday everywhere.
To all those dads who choose the minivan over the sports car, the vacation in Orlando over Antigua, chicken fingers over chicken cordon bleu, here's a Father's Day reminder. Those days are numbered. Retirement savings from the AIG companies. Retirement loans insurance. AIG. We know money.
Colorado Z71 with an available 220 horsepower engine.
You're it.
Don't let all that power go to your head. Chevy Colorado, an American revolution.
Got athlete's foot? Think fast. Lamisil AT cures athlete's foot with just 1 week's use. If you use Tenactin or Lotrimin AF, you'll be treated for 4 long weeks. But 1 week with Lamisil AT keeps you athlete's foot free for 3 months.
There's no better way to cure athlete's foot.
Hey, man, it's me, Gary. Gary Payton. You know I dream about being with you every night.
I left behind my job, my friends. I even took a pay cut. And do you know what houses cost around here? And I did it all for you. The glove has got the love. Come with me, baby. Show me a sign.
Aerial coverage tonight being provided by the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company, reminding you to enjoy the drive on Goodyear's new Assurance tires. That's the Palace of Auburn Hills. It's about 32 miles from Detroit. Kid Rock and Hank Williams. Hank, are you ready for some hoops?
Yeah, boy, that's a heck of a combination right there.
I would say. Interesting duet they could provide us with. 25-24, second quarter, Al Michaels, Doc Rivers, Michelle Tafoya, and let's check in with Stuart Scott.
Al, interesting in the last timeout, Larry Brown did acknowledge to his team that Shaq has two fouls, but he also said spread the offense, meaning make sure you continue to run our offense. He even looked at his big man and he said, stop trying to get the fouls, try to score. Al?
Thank you, Stuart.
And that is really significant because what players and teams do, they focus so much on trying to draw the foul on Shaq that it actually takes them out of their rhythm and their offense.
That was Williamson dropping in the first points of the period. Kareem Rush is in the game. So is Derek Fisher. And Kobe has the ball stolen. Pistons rush back. Hamilton drives in. And Rush commits the foul. Pistons just forcing the issue in this entire series, moving the ball around, getting through the middle, forcing the Lakers to commit fouls.
Yeah, they really are. They're getting so deep with the dribble penetration that either you foul them or you give them an easy two, and that's been their game plan throughout. Now, the only change so far in this game and in this series is today or tonight the Lakers are trying to do the same thing. Even that last shot, Kobe Bryant got it stolen from him, but he is trying to attack the basket. I think that's the right thing if you're the Lakers.
Hamilton misses the first of two. Billups is the leading scorer with six. The Pistons, you talk about spreading it out and balanced scoring, they have six guys who have between 4 and 6 points. The Lakers, meanwhile, have Bryant now with six. Medvedenko had a quick eight. He's on the bench right now. Walton in the corner, feeds it to O'Neal. 5 on the 24. Back to Shaq, and Shaq gets held as he's going to the basket by Rasheed Wallace.
You know, it's interesting. I don't think Larry Brown wanted that, you know, because it was Rasheed Wallace. You know, he needs Rasheed Wallace to stay in this game. Now, Rasheed Wallace commits the foul because Shaq gets so deep, and it saves him a bucket, but it hurts him because Wallace has to come out of the game.
For the fourth time in 5 games, Rasheed Wallace has to take an early seat with his two fouls. Shaq tries to hand off to Kobe, and Lindsey Hunter got in between them to commit the foul. Here's Michelle.
Well, Al, since the last game, Phil Jackson spoke with Kobe Bryant about the things they wanted him to do tonight in this game, and I'll finish up after this play.
Fisher for three.
Al, what Phil wanted from Kobe tonight were the things that he did in game two, the game that they won. Play off the ball, get easy baskets, move without the basketball, be a distributor, and when he does have the ball, distribute the ball, and then the game will come to him. That's what they're looking from Kobe Bryant tonight, guys.
All right, Michelle, that last foul was on Elgin Campbell. Now Bryant nearly has it taken away and does, in fact, by the hands of Hunter, leading to a Hamilton break and dunk.
Kobe Bryant just did exactly what Phil Jackson didn't want him to do. I mean, right there, he tried to split between two guys, which would be very difficult, and he turns the ball over. That's his second turnover now for buckets for the Pistons because he's trying to force the action.
6-point lead inside to Shaq, puts it up and in.
But if you're the Lakers again, it's a 4-point game, and now the Pistons have 3 team fouls early into the second quarter.
And the Pistons are hot after they were down by 7 in the first quarter. They scored on 12 of 14 possessions. Williamson is guarded by Kobe Bryant. And reaching in is Derek Fisher, and he's going to get called for it. Back to the steal by Hunter and the Hamilton breakaway.
I mean, again, you can see Kobe Bryant trying to force the action, and that's the second time he's tried to split between guys. And that's what Kobe Bryant does extremely well, except for the Pistons now know that. They're playing them for that, and that's the second turnover for Bucket that he's caused.
Hunter out of the corner, and Ben Wallace in perfect position to grab the rebound. He's as good as it gets off the glass.
He is. And those hands are like glue. When they touch his hands, it sticks.
Williamson missing. Man, I just love to watch the way Wallace sets up, especially on those shots from the corner. He knows exactly where to be for the rebound. Perfectly positioned. Fisher from deep outside. Got it. Three-pointer to Derek. Saluted by Malone. It's a one-point game.
And again, great ball movement. And on that shot, Fisher didn't hesitate.
Fisher, one of those Lakers playing hurt. Half the roster playing hurt. But playing nonetheless. Hamilton throws it away. And now Kobe's on a break. And Kobe's going to put this one in, looking to see where Hunter was, seeing if he could get a three-point play out of it. And it's 31-30 Los Angeles.
I think he didn't think Hunter could catch up to him. And he did. This is the big foul here. Again, you know the silly fouls that Phil Jackson talks about away from the action. That is what just happened. And this is why the Lakers have been in penalty all series.
Can't stay out of their own way. 31-30, Los Angeles.
Now you tease my plug one style and my plug one spectacle. You said plug one and two are hit.
I have told a ridiculous lie
to back up a friend's ridiculous lie.
I've just ordered a Coors Light for everyone in this bar. Put it on my buddy's tab.
I have used my dog to dry my hands.
I have no idea what this girl's name is.
I have dated a girl for her brains.
Big.
Huge.
Brains.
Great achievements deserve a great beer. Unleash the Rocky Mountain cold taste of Coors Light.
He's put together a really nice run here.
Yeah, oh, look at that. That hurt.
Hey, Lou, what's this? Someone's entered the arena. Get that guy out of here for crying out loud.
It's Cyclone time.
I'll tell you, he doesn't see him. This could get ugly.
Oh!
Oh, my. I have no words for what we've just seen. I'm speechless. Utterly incomprehensible.
This year, let NBA players make you money. Win big with Verizon Wireless by casting your vote for the Finals MVP. Just text NBA to the number 622 to participate. Then during a deciding game of the Finals, you'll be sent a ballot. Vote for your favorite player, and every game you vote, you're entered in our sweepstakes for a chance to win a $10,000 shopping spree at Radio Shack. So text NBA to the number 622 now for a chance to score big. Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you.
Dodgeball rule number 15.
Let me hit you with some knowledge.
The game is 90% mental.
You should quit now.
I think I'll take my chances in the tournament.
You will take your chances.
That's what you said.
Well, that's what I'm saying to you.
All right.
Touché.
Dodgeball, rated PG-13, Friday.
Looking for high performance in your wireless laptop? Unwire. With a laptop powered by Intel Centrino mobile technology.
Friday, Madonna lets loose.
Yikes, just stop right there.
And sparks will fly.
I'm a rebel.
Uncensored, unpredictable.
I can't say bad words on TV, but...
Friday, it's the Madonna interview that'll have everyone talking. 2020, Friday at 10, 9 Central.
All right, Doc, I'll see you. I've got two jacks. What do you have?
I have one right there.
Wait, one and a half
one
jacks.
Real one.
Well, Jack on the right, the two... Wallace's of sorts. Jack Nicholson hitting the road.
Brave man Jack Nicholson is, you know. I remember he went into Boston one time and braved the elements also. My first Boston reference of the night.
In a while, I like that. Doc, of course, will be the coach of the Celtics next year. Game of runs right there. Lakers started hot. Then Shaq sat down for a minute and a half, and the Pistons were off and going. And now after Fisher committed the foul on the inbounds play, which means Ben Wallace is at the line for two. He makes the first. Fisher working on Jackson's behalf with Bennett Salvatore.
And if you're wondering why they're shooting free throws, Al, it's because the ball had not been inbounded, so it's an automatic two free throws. And there's Kobe Bryant again attacking the basket. Now, that's a good thing. You want him to do that. What you don't want him to do is try to split and force the action.
And turn the ball over or commit an offensive foul. That foul on Hunter. Game tied at 31, 8:45 to go, first half. Fisher gets it back into O'Neal. Can't get it. Hunter comes away with it. Campbell. Pistons love to force the ball up the floor. One of the reasons is it makes Shaq work that much harder.
Yeah, it's like chopping a tree down. They say it may not give them make a big deal for the first three quarters, but by the fourth quarter, they don't think Shaq can keep running.
Hamilton gets free. Back door.
And that's a rare sight that you will see Rip Hamilton driving towards Shaq and Shaq getting out of the way. But that's because of the two fouls.
Bad pass, and it results in nearly a Piston basket, but at least they go to the free throw line.
Well, I tell you, talking to Phil this morning, two of the things he said we couldn't do is, one, we couldn't make silly fouls. They're making them. Two, he said, we cannot turn the ball over and allow them to get easy buckets. And they are doing it at a high rate right now.
They turned it over seven times in the first 16 minutes of the game. Log on to the NBA store, NBA.com. All the good stuff right there, NBA.com.
You know, what Phil Jackson is saying is that he believes that his team has actually played good defense, minus the turnovers, which are easy buckets, and the fouls.
Payton comes back in. Kareem Rush departs. Gets the bounce. And Detroit's lead is four.
And if you're Larry Brown, you like the way your team is playing. You know, they're just out there playing like they play and not thinking about anything else.
Walton drives all the way. Can't get it to drop. And then going to the floor was Eldon Campbell. A 3-on-2 here. Fed underneath. Williamson misses it, but gets it back. Juggles it. Keeps possession. And Hamilton will now start to drive. Williamson. Shot clock in single figures. Hamilton, fall away. Couldn't get control of the ball, but got hit. And fouled. Payton. Jackson's up, arms folded, in effect thinking to himself, you know what, that's a foul, but they did it to Kobe before and it's not a foul?
That's what I think the Lakers are saying right now. Now, I will say that Derek Fisher and Payton are the two trickiest defenders in this league. And I think what Bennett Salvatore is saying, he saw them do something tricky, and I think what he saw them do is tap him on the elbow.
Fisher with three fouls now. And Rick Fox comes into the game. So Fox makes his first appearance. And Detroit up by six again. So after they had a six-point lead and the Lakers overcame it, Detroit up 37-31. Walton, too high for Bryant. Try to time it. Kobe got underneath. Another turnover. And then Detroit throws it away, but it was last touched by the Lakers.
Yeah, that was a fastball lob. You know, usually you're supposed to lob it nice and soft. There was no one quick enough to jump and catch that pass that Luke Walton just threw.
Larry Brown didn't like that possession. And if Larry doesn't like a possession, he doesn't care how hot his team is. He says, timeout. Let's come back and play the right way. They're playing the right way to this point in Game 5 on a night they can win it all. Detroit 37, Los Angeles 31.
I can't tell you. Introducing the all-new Toyota Tundra Double Cab. Not just big, life-sized.
I'd like to tell you a little story about my grandparents. They had a refrigerator that they knitted themselves out of yarn. It was small, not very cold, but it taught me a valuable lesson. Not all of us have king-sized refrigerators. And that's why Miller brings you the space-saving fridge pack. It proves once again that Miller is a beer of the people. Plus, it's got this little lip here that keeps the beers from tumbling out.
Choose great beer and great boxes, Miller. Good call.
Let's play.
The number one action movie in America is The Chronicles of Riddick. It's pure adrenaline, a high-powered adventure, a visual thrill. One of the best sci-fi films ever. The Chronicles of Riddick, rated PG-13.
Taco Bell's new Ranchero Chicken Soft Taco. Marinated grilled all-white meat chicken, freshly prepared fiesta salsa, and a zesty avocado ranch sauce. So much great taste, you'll be floored by flavor. For a burst of fresh flavor, think outside the bun.
One day, you'll see me. My number, you'll be screaming. One day, you'll say I'm number one.
Perfect homes, perfect lawns, the perfect place to hide a secret. Something is buried on Wisteria Lane. Desperate Housewives, Sundays this fall on ABC.
The NBA Finals on ABC, brought to you by Miller. Vote Miller for President of Beers. Good call. The Toyota Tundra Double Cab, not just big, life-size. Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers. And Universal Pictures, The Chronicles of Riddick, now in theaters.
Palace of Auburn Hills. About 10 o'clock local time. The Lakers, as play resumes, on the short end of a 7-0 run in the last 147. The second such run in a short period of time for Detroit. And they'll inbound with 19 seconds on the clock. Underneath, Billups reverse, puts it in. So Chauncey Billups got it in, got it back, and Chauncey Billups now has 8 points. Biggest margin in the game. O'Neal's going to drive. Too hard. Stolen by Bryant. And Bryant, as he's moving down the court, gets fouled. Fouled by Tayshaun Prince.
I think what they're going to do, Al, is say that Kobe Bryant was ahead of everybody, and they're going to give him a shot and the ball out of bounds.
They were near, close enough to a breakaway.
And there again, on that last replay, you saw another uncontested layup by the Detroit Pistons.
That is the height of frustration. You get, in effect, a free throw,
yeah,
and you can't make it.
Well, here it is. You know, what they're saying is he had a clear path to the basket. No one was in front of him. He led the pack, so you can't foul. It's a good call.
And then one of the best free throw shooters in the NBA can't drop it. The Lakers inbound it. 6.5 to go first half. Bryant working off an O'Neal screen. Goes all the way, puts it up, and it doesn't go, but it'll go to the line.
See, that's what they want Kobe Bryant to do. And that was terrific execution. They swung the ball to the left, acting like the ball was going to go there. And then Shaq came up from the bottom and gave a terrific pick, which allows Kobe to split and get into the paint. And you can see there the foul on the arm.
Lakers are now 3 out of 4 from the line. Kobe Bryant is the only Laker who has been to the free throw line tonight.
You know, what's interesting is Kobe Bryant is the one Laker that has probably been the most surprising that hasn't gone to the line in this series. But to me, the difference is tonight, Kobe Bryant is not settling. He's attacking the basket.
Attacking, and of course, the Lakers will tell you on the other side, they're just not getting the calls. But the one thing Jackson didn't do before this game is start to bait the referees through the media. Bill's been pretty quiet about that over the last 48 hours. Or 40, anyway.
Yeah,
he had to say after game four. Hamilton misses. Medvedenko back in the game and takes it off the glass.
I think Phil Jackson likes this switch with Kobe Bryant guarding Billups.
Bryant, too hard. Prince. Behind the back, great move to get by Bryant. Does it again and can't get it to drop. It'll go to the line. Two behind the back dribbles.
And again, getting all the way to the bucket. Every long rebound, every turnover, the Detroit Pistons have pushed the ball up. And if you don't stop the ball, they're going to continue to go until they get all the way to the bucket.
Who grew up idolizing Kobe Bryant. You know, I say he idolizes Bryant as Okur and James come into the game. There's only a couple of years differential, but Kobe's been playing in the NBA so long, and Tayshaun French wound up going to college for 4 years. I guess you become an idol.
Yeah, you do, and Kobe became an idol pretty quickly in this league.
There are guys in their 30s who idolize Kobe. 7-point Detroit lead. 5:40 left in the half. Okur guarding O'Neal, who gets it back from Medvedenko. Puts it up, gets fouled.
See, again, Shaq's being patient. They're moving the ball. They're attacking the basket. I think one point has to be made about this free throw discrepancy, Al. You know, the Lakers are led the league in free throw shooting most of the league all year because they led most of the games and teams went to hack-a-shack. They've never had a lead in this series, so the Detroit Pistons really haven't had to go to hack-a-shack, and I think that's one of the big differences in this series.
That's anathema to a purist like Larry Brown as well. He doesn't want to do it. Free throw attempt differential, as you can see, the difference in the finals as opposed to the regular season. In the first three rounds, Medvedenko got the rebound after two O'Neal misses. Now Bryant puts one up. Kobe stays cold. Bryant is 3 of 10 from the floor. And Payton tries to steal, can't keep it in bounds.
You know, Bryant is 3 of 10. But most of his shots tonight, in my opinion, have been pretty good. The couple of forced opportunities have led to turnovers. I think as a coach, you have to live with those because he is so creative.
Pistons, meanwhile, are hitting 57% from the field. And since they've been going to the free throw line more often, that's a tough combo to beat. And Ben Wallace is too tough to beat right there, and the lead is 9.
And that's huge when you're Detroit. And you can drop the ball into Ben Wallace and get points out of him. That is huge.
Whistle on the way to the basket.
I mean, one of the things Larry Brown has done since coming to Detroit, he's made Ben Wallace an offensive option. He tells his team to look for him when he's on a post, and he's made Ben Wallace think offense. Ben Wallace a couple of years ago would have never made that move. Now when he gets the ball, he feels pretty comfortable. And you look tonight, he's 3 for 3 with 7 points.
O'Neal makes his first free throw here. He's now 1 out of 3. Lakers had an early 7-point lead. There's Wallace tipping it to himself. Great body control, kept it inbounds. His huge hands. Able to pot. And now Detroit tries to cash it. Wallace. Wow. ...44-34. The lead is double digits. Jackson not calling a timeout. Still believes in conflict resolution. They got a lot to resolve right now. And Kobe got blocked and fouled.
And boy, I tell you, that was close. That was real close. Mike James almost got there and slid up under Kobe. And watch his foot and see if he was still moving at the very end. He was. That was an excellent call. Mm-hmm. But boy, that was close. I think if Mike James didn't try to draw the contact himself, he would have had a charge.
Bryant now 5 out of 6 from the free throw line. Drops them both. Pistons up by 8. Fox picks up Prince and back to it. James way outside. He provided a big spark with him in just a very short period of time late in the first half the other night. Okur. Mehmet Okur.
And Mehmet Dinko right now, even though he's giving him some offense, is a defensive liability for this Laker basketball team. He's getting scored on from all angles.
And the call here on the Lakers. That's on Shaquille, so that's his third. He picked up 2 early ones. Third one here away from the ball.
And so now we have a crisis time right now for the Los Angeles Lakers. They have 3:36. They're down 10 points, and they probably will not see Shaq the rest of this half. This is key.
Jackson left O'Neal in the last game of the Minnesota series, the conference finals, and he picked up a 4th foul in the first quarter. From the corner, in and out from Prince, Medvedenko gets the rebound. So O'Neal on the bench, Malone in street clothes. Fox posting Prince. Turnaround off the glass, and Rick Banks at home to make it an 8-point game.
And Rick Fox has been begging to play. You know, one of the points he made was pretty interesting. He said, hey, everybody else is playing injured. I would like to play injured also. And, you know, when a player like him asks to come in, it's pretty smart that you see Phil Jackson play him in.
Wow. We're looking every which way. Coffee safe, water safe. But the Lakers are in danger. Pistons lead by 8.
At the Bud Light Institute, we're proud that our beer is made with all natural ingredients and is low in carbs. So few, in fact, it's easy to burn the carbs in one Bud Light. That's why we've created the Mini Treadmill 2010. Use your treadmill at home, on the town, even in the gym. And it stores conveniently away till you need to use it again. Order yours today. Fresh, smooth, real. Bud Light, it's all here.
I like things in life that are the best. My best friend. Best shortcuts. The best cuts. And of course, the best place for these. My son. Chris, let me call you back. I'm a little busy.
Now at Radio Shack, get hot deals for Father's Day. Like a Sprint PCS Vision Ready Link Phone RL4920 by Sanyo. Just $49.99 with 2-year agreement.
Did I mention the best sport?
Radio Shack.
John, okay. Okay, Mike, I know you think your truck is totally sick, but this is what I think of your precious 4x4 hang out all day with your stupid friend's truck! Push it!
All right, Tim. 80,000 all in. Okay, all right. Forget about that. I was just kidding. 72.5. Say no more. Moonroof, extended warranty. Stop me at any time. Titanium wheels package. After that, I mean, you're cutting into my, which you don't care about. I got nothing else, Tim. Done.
Yes.
Ooh. Did you know you were going 65? Okay, 55.
Mike Tirico, Byron Scott, and Tom Tolbert upstairs, ready to bring you the Verizon Wireless halftime report. Look at Ben Wallace going right by Medvedenko, putting one in from about 10 feet. And what Ben likes to do before the game, as we know, Doc, is take the big ball, take a bigger ball, and try to make baskets with it. It's kind of like being out on the putting green. You know, you have those tiny little holes.
I knew where you were going.
Of course, but we share the same
doubt. Same passion. You know, it's funny, too, because that ball was really invented for ball handling. Mm-hmm. Ben Wallace has turned it into a shooting gimmick, which some guys do use it for that, and it's really paid off for him.
It's working tonight, and there he is again. Big ball, small ball, and that was after they had about half of the 24-second clock to work with on the inbound. 10-point lead. Phil Jackson was telling us earlier today one of the things the Lakers had to do was hold their turnovers to 8 or less. The Lakers have already turned the ball over 9 times in the first half.
And the reason he's saying that is because he says that they played pretty good defense in half court. What they can't do is give Detroit easy buckets, and that's exactly what they've done.
Cook gets doubled in the corner. Nowhere to go with it. 4 on the shot clock. After Rush, he's got to shoot. He does at the horn and makes it. Kareem Rush, who was so big in the clinching game against Minnesota, was 6 three-pointers.
Boy, that was a huge bucket, and it was amazing how unrushed Rush was. Did that make sense?
Perfect. Doc, that's why you can't coach. You got to come back here next year. From the corner, a three-pointer for Okur. Big answers big. Bryant. Back to Cook. Minute and a half to go in the period.
Well, there is no spacing right now for the Lakers.
And Kobe is the line drive one over Okur and French.
I mean, their spacing was so bad. You know, the difference in the first half right now is it looks like the Detroit Pistons offense is executing to a T. And right now, the Lakers are scoring almost out of their offense.
Shot is short. Rebound keeps getting tipped. Winds up in the hands of Prince. He'll drive all the way. Brings the house down. The Pistons in this series just eating the Lakers up on the offensive glass.
And that's length and athleticism coming together at the same time on that last possession. The ball stayed up in the air, and they got both.
20-second Laker timeout.
We designed them to be trusted with our homes, our children, our lives. But did we design them to be trusted?
Murder's a new trick for a robot.
I did not murder him!
My robots don't kill people.
That thing threw somebody out of a window. Is that registering with you?
There is no conspiracy. What this is one mistake.
Hell no.
You trust them if you want to.
iRobot, July 16th. This film is not yet rated.
Back in Detroit, 10-point lead for the Pistons. Al, this is what we're talking about. You know, a good drive, but watch, the ball stays up in the air. And if you're longer, quicker, and more athletic, usually you come up with the rebounds, and that's where the Pistons have taken advantage of the Lakers in this series.
Night after night, first time in this series, either team's had a 50-point first half. Bryant puts one up.
Well, I think the Pistons love when he settles. They love when he settles for the fadeaway jump shot, even though it is one of his staple shots. With Tayshaun Prince's length, they will take that shot all game.
Pistons eating up the Laker defense. Okur drives. Crosby puts it in. And they lead by 12 with Jack on the bench, Malone and Sibby. And a game away from elimination. Okur has 7. Medvedenko will drive to the basket and get fouled on his way to the hoop.
You know, in a perfect world, if you're Phil Jackson, you would have loved Nabedenko to back it out and take the final shot and just have a 4-second differential. But you can't pass up layups right now when you're down 12.
Third foul on Okur. Nabedenko makes the first. WNBA coming up Saturday. The Detroit Shock, they are the champions, and owned by Bill Davidson, who's seeking this title. He has that title and the Stanley Cup. The Tampa Bay Sacramento is the opposition Saturday. ABC.
Well, I've heard of the Tiger Slam. I guess this would be the Davis Slam if he gets this.
Nabedenko trying to become the first Laker apart from O'Neal and Bryant to go into double figures, and that's a small consolation to Phil Jackson right now, because his team is going to go into the locker room trailing in a season in which they were built to win this title.
And this year only.
Because it'll be a different team next year. And the Pistons right now trying to make it a dozen points if they can. And James puts it up and doesn't have it. And they're only a fraction of a second left on the clock. It's the largest halftime lead for either team in the series. The Detroit fell behind by 7 early. They put Shaq on the bench. They caught him. The lead seesawed a little bit. And now Detroit with a great run in the second quarter. They outscored the Lakers 30-21. And Detroit leads 55-45 at the half. We go to Stuart Scott.
Ben Wallace, 11 points. You guys are shooting over 60%. You're the Pistons. You don't shoot 60%. What's going on?
I mean, that's what confidence do for you. You know, we got some stops. We was able to get some clean looks. And tonight, the shots just falling for us.
Why are fast break points? You guys got a bunch of them. Why are they so important for this game?
Because, you know, they got the big fella down inside. And if you slow the game down, allow him to get position, you know, he going to bang you all night. So we want to get out and make him run a little bit, try to wear him down.
24 minutes away from what could be a championship, what's your biggest concern at halftime?
Just that we don't come out a little bit, you know, over-aggressive. You know, we got to stay poised, continue to execute our offensive set, continue to get stops, and allow the game to come to us.
All right, Ben, appreciate it. Good luck in the second half. Right, Al, let's go back to you.
Thank you, Stuart. The Verizon Wireless halftime report comes your way. The commissioner will be interviewed. David Stern will be along to talk with the guys upstairs as the teams retreat to their respective locker rooms. Detroit is on top 55-45 as they try to win their first title since 1990. Halftime in Auburn Hills.
Six children, 18 grandchildren, 35 great-grandchildren. Everyone's there for each other. Need a tune-up? Call Uncle Ray. Need work? Call Aunt Grace. Need insurance? Just ask around. Allstate has helped the family for 59 years, starting with great-grandma Johnson. And Allstate has what it takes to be there for generations to come. Experience is what keeps your agent in the family. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
Living room you can track sand through. $0. Dining room where you can laugh with your mouth full. $0. Bedroom where you can stay up way past your bedtime. $0. Weekend house rules. Priceless. Use your MasterCard and you could win your own weekend house in our Weekends Matter sweepstakes.
McDonald's and Sony Connect are hooking up for the greatest music deal in history. Every time you buy a Big Mac meal, you get a free song. Just go to connect.com to get your access to hundreds of thousands of hot tracks.
At CDW, we ship over 100,000 IT products to customers every day. So how can we do it even faster? One word, wormholes.
Want the freedom of wireless fast? Get a powerful IBM ThinkPad with Centrino technology starting at just $15.99 with eligible trade-in.
Now I just need to figure out that whole space-time continuum thing.
For top-brand IT products shipped out fast, you can always count on CDW for the right technology right away.
So this is a great first date. Y'all look delicious. I mean, pretty. Sometimes they know me up in this joint. I pop a couple collars. You know?
Hello. Can I take your order?
Yeah, I'll help.
Yeah, you can take my order.
Let me get 3 number 5s. 12, 8.
You got an ear infection.
7. That's what Marvin wants. Yeah.
Unleash the Rocky Mountain cold taste of Coors Light.
I remember this one time I was after this fine lady from over there on King Boulevard. I couldn't get nowhere, nohow.
That's because you're ugly.
Man, I'm so lost.
You really in love, ain't you, Ben?
She's all I think about. Night, day, day and night. I got it bad.
Real bad?
Real bad.
Trophy, no. I've seen it before, but never like this.
Live from the Palace of Auburn Hills, it's the Verizon Wireless Halftime Report from the NBA Finals. Now, your host, Mike Tirico.
You look down at the Palace of Auburn Hills, where the Pistons may win a title in Detroit for the first time ever. Ben Wallace, 5 of 5 from the field in that first half. Pistons, as Al mentioned, not only a series high, but a playoff high in the first half, 55 points. Some of the sounds of Motown, the Great Temptations, midcourt entertaining the fans who have seen some good moves in the first half from the other guys from Detroit here at the Pistons. Welcome to the Verizon Wireless Halftime Report with the coach of the New Orleans Hornets, Byron Scott, and Tom Tolbert, Mike Tirico. Shaquille O'Neal, 3 fouls. Kobe Bryant in early foul trouble. Field goals not going again. The Lakers came with the energy, but the Pistons were able to match it, Byron.
Yeah, they did come with the energy, but I think you got to give Detroit a lot of credit because Detroit came with energy as well, and they executed their game plan to perfection. Offensively, they executed extremely well, and when that ball went up in the air and they got the rebound, they tried to make Shaq get up and down the court, got a lot of easy baskets, and they could continue to be that aggressive. The second half, we'll be celebrating a Detroit Pistons championship tonight.
To that point, with Shaquille O'Neal in the game, the Pistons have scored 2 more points. Tom, when Shaq's been on the bench, the Pistons are +8. Show me why.
Well, because there's a hole in the middle. I mean, when Shaq is in the game, he's in the middle, he's commanding the paint area. When he's not in the middle, you see guys taking advantage of that and getting to the rim. Right here, Rasheed Wallace, where's the shot blocker? There isn't one. Chauncey Billups knows that. Defense opens up, take it in the middle. There is no shot blocker. Tayshaun Prince, again, dishing it off to Ben Wallace. There is no shot blocker. And interestingly enough, if you watch Detroit in the Eastern Conference Finals, this would be a fourth quarter score, 55 right. points, and you're wondering, how could they do that? Well, it's a Lakers problem they've had all season long. They're not a good defensive squad.
It's the first time in 6 years and a day that a team from the Eastern Conference has been on the floor with a chance to win the title. Jordan and the Bulls, 98. Last time that was the case, Kobe Bryant, 4 of 12 in the first half. He and the Lakers down 10. The commissioner of the NBA, David Stern, joins us live next.
The Verizon Wireless Halftime Report, brought to you by Verizon Wireless, the only wireless provider that allows you to vote for the NBA Finals MVP.
Can you hear me now? Good. Thomas Schmidt.
Schmidt!
It's tough being the first one of my college friends to get a job. We like to talk a lot.
Guess how many cookies I have in my mouth? Come on, just guess.
6. That's why we all joined in.
Join in and make free calls to any Verizon Wireless customer anytime without using any plan minutes from our national in coverage area.
Bring home toilet paper.
Is your group in? Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
Optimism has always been celebrated with a bell. And every day when this bell rings, it's a symbol of our pledge to serve the investor with new standards, new leadership, and a renewed commitment to being the best market on earth. It's your market, and there's only one trade that really matters here. Yours. The New York Stock Exchange.
Coming to DVD, nothing is off limits at the barbershop.
Lenny Kravitz.
Eminem.
Brad Pitt.
Vin Diesel.
Mel Gibson.
Luther Vandross.
You ain't going too far now.
I can't talk about Luther Vandross.
No.
What you gonna do about it?
Barbershop 2 on DVD, June 29th. It's the latest buzz in technology.
Intel Centrino mobile technology enables long battery life in a laptop. Get charged up at intel.com.
To all those dads who choose the minivan over the sports car, the vacation in Orlando over Antigua, chicken fingers over chicken cordon bleu, here's a Father's Day reminder. Those days are numbered. Retirement savings from the AIG companies. Retirement loans insurance. AIG. We know money.
To the Verizon Wireless Halftime Report, live from the Palace of Auburn Hills. Richard Hamilton had 11. He continues to be step-for-step scoring-wise with Kobe Bryant in this series. The Pistons 24 minutes away from a third franchise title. We are joined by the commissioner of the NBA, David Stern, for an annual visit. It's appropriate that we are in this building, David, the building that led the league in attendance in a year when the NBA had more people in the house than ever before.
It's been a great year, and there's no question that Detroit has been at the vanguard. And they have a very young group of fans here. It's fun to see.
There are a million great stories in the NBA in our couple of minutes. Let's just get to some of the hot button issues. And let's start with the comments made by Larry Bird to our colleague Jim Gray during an ESPN interview last week. For those of you who didn't see it, Bird made this comment about white superstars in the league or lack thereof. I think it's good for a fan base because, as we all know, the majority of the fans are white America. And if you just had a couple of white guys in there, you might get them a little excited, but it's a black man's game. You've always listened to your great players during your tenure to hear what they have to say. They have their finger on the pulse of the league. First, your reaction to Larry's statement.
Well, I listen to them. I don't always agree with them, as great as they may be. I think that was the conventional wisdom when Larry came into the league in 1979. If anything, the last 25 years, the years of Magic and Michael, Kobe, Shaq, this Piston team, our great American fans love winners and people of great talent. You look at Tiger Woods and the like. On this one, Larry's just flat out wrong.
So, in your opinion, does the NBA need a white superstar to help growth of the league?
I don't understand how we could grow it. Our ratings were up. Our attendance is up. Our sponsorship is up. Everything is up. On this one, again, Larry is wrong. Great player and evaluator of talent, though he may be.
Speaking of ratings, a topic we covered last year, ratings for the finals have been great. A lot of people are watching. Certainly the presence of the Lakers, your flagship franchise, for lack of a better word, helps that. Do you worry, though, that when the Lakers aren't in, it's a notch below in ratings, in excitement for fans? Is this league too Laker-dependent for success right now?
I don't think so. I think that the East, ESPN set an all-time basketball record with the Pacers and the Pistons.
The clinching game, most watched.
I think that we're really seeing a transition. Obviously, people love the Lakers and love to hate the Lakers, and maybe there's a bump. But this, you don't have the attendance that we have, the overall ratings that we have, and everything else that goes with success with just one team.
Let me ask you about the Olympics. 8 or 9 players, for a variety of legitimate reasons, have pulled out of the games in Athens in August. You helped save USA basketball by the Dream Team concept. Do you feel in any way a responsibility to get more of your players to go to the Olympics down the line past Athens?
We didn't save USA basketball. They were doing fine. The fact of the matter is that FIBA and the IOC asked us to release our players, mm-hmm. and we agreed to. And I think it's great that our players have the right to participate in the Olympics and the right not to.
But the Dream Team certainly put Olympic basketball in a far different stratosphere.
Absolutely. Right. But that was really one of a kind. I think that we're going to have a very good team. I certainly think it's up to the individual. But obviously, we would like to participate in fielding the strongest possible team. But no arm twisting here.
No arm twisting from you.
No arm twisting.
Age limit. We talked about it last year. You said, in a great world, you'd like to see an age limit of 20, perhaps, in the collective bargaining agreement. If that would have been in this year, LeBron James, who's given the league as great a blip in interest as anyone, wouldn't have been in the league. Did it change your opinion at all if there should be an age limit or not?
No, because I know that players can play at a younger age. But if that were the case, then there's a great 14-year-old player I know. Maybe we should have him. It isn't about the player who can play. It's about the impact of playing in the NBA on kids who are bouncing the ball at the age of 10 and 11, think they're coming to us, and the increasing number of youngsters who are going to declare because their friends are telling them how good they are, and they're going to fall out. Finally, there's a business reason. In some ways, teams are using their draft picks, and I think they should also have the ability to make certain judgments on more than just potential.
Last question. It's been 13 months since Michael Jordan has been directly attached to an NBA franchise.
Michael.
Remember him, Michael, 23 guy?
Yeah, I know him.
Is there anything in the works? Do you think there's anything that might happen in the next 6 months that Michael will be back with a team?
I think there's something that's going to happen. I'm not going to put a time limit on it. Michael is traveling the world, doing quite well, but also using his very practiced eye on the business sense to see if there's an opportunity for franchise ownership.
Any places you'd like to mention with us right now?
No.
Okay.
But thank you for asking.
No problem. Thank you for coming up. Great to see you, David. Maybe we'll see you at the trophy presentation if it happens after the second half. Ben Wallace has done his part to do that. Wallace went 8 of 10 in the clinching game against the Nets in the Eastern Conference second round. He's 5 of 5 tonight. Detroit leads by 10. Alan Dock at half two coming up right after this.
This halftime report presented by Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you. The second half is next after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Can you hear me now? Good.
Have a good summer. See you next season. I'm going to miss you guys.
Stay close when you and your friends join in and make free calls to any Verizon Wireless customer anytime without using any planned minutes from our national in-coverage area. Plus, buy any LG phone and get a VX3200 free.
Man, I can't wait to play next year. Yeah, me too.
Is your group in?
Good.
Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
Squash Saturday, you and me.
I don't play squash.
You do now.
Understand the past, dominate the future.
Punch for the ball.
Punch for the ball. Keep the body still.
Good.
Go for the short swing.
Just watch his backhand.
We'll get you some goggles.
And it's on sale.
You, let's go.
Remember the kill shot.
Life's better with the butterfly. Come see all the ways you can get more done at MSN.com.
Now on DVD.
You cost us the game!
I just want to play football.
Playmakers, the most controversial series of the season.
Who is she?
This is who you are.
With Smash Mouth extras.
I will snap you at the knee!
Playmakers, the 3-disc box set. Only today.
When you're the shyest of 5 brothers...
Are you trying to ask me to the dance?
You can always count on your family for help. New breed of family. Fridays this fall on ABC.
The number one German beer in America is A, actually German, B, more popular than the other German beers, C, Beck's, D, all of the above. Life beckons, and you're holding the key.
That can of dip, please.
Beck's Light is perfect for anyone who's interested in A, fewer calories, B, fewer carbs, C, fewer clothes.
Life beckons, and you're holding the key.
Severe weather hits the Delaware Valley again tonight. We'll have the latest tonight after the game.
Second half ready to begin. Detroit up by 10 points at the Palace. Al Michaels with Doc Rivers, Michelle Tafoya, Stuart Scott. A lot of different things we can talk about, but again, one of the things, Doc, is the fact that the Pistons are having their way against that Laker defense. Lakers started out pretty good, defending almost every shot, and then all of a sudden they became a sieve again.
And that's been a staple of this series. All series long, the Lakers have come out and played defense for, you know, a quarter or maybe a couple of possessions, but they haven't been able to maintain it throughout the games. And this is what you see when the Lakers don't play defense. You see layup after layup after layup. And this is not just this game. It's been the entire series. They're running on all cylinders, 61% from the field, 10 layups, three of those are dunks, 11 points from Ben Wallace, who's not an offensive player, and they've had a ton of wide open shots that don't even count as layups.
26 points from not only in the paint, but you're in the easel, I guess, at that point. I mean, you're right there. Layups, yeah. Dunks, you know, and the Lakers are right now in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, I will say this, though. Shaq left. They're down 10. He comes back. They're still down 10. I think that's significant.
Back he comes at the start of the second half. We go to Stewart.
Al, I asked Larry Brown what he told his team about making this just one simple half of basketball. And he said, I really told them, just keep doing what you're doing. Do your job and you'll be fine. But then he smiled and he said, but I did tell them, enjoy this. And I told them several times. For report of the Lakers, let's go to Michelle Tafoya.
Stewart, as I was standing outside the Laker locker room during halftime, something very unusual happened. A Laker official came out of the locker room and shushed people in the hallway. Things were obviously getting tense inside that locker room. Kurt Rambis told me players were attentive, were overplaying guys on D, were allowing them to penetrate. Back to you guys.
And this begins, the second half does, with a Rasheed Wallace three-pointer.
Boy, and that's a big one. I know it's early in the second half. Rasheed Wallace really didn't get involved in the first half, and Larry Brown came out of the halftime making sure that Rasheed Wallace touched the ball.
Here's O'Neal. And the Lakers will need a lot of that.
I was going to say, Bill Jackson came out and he said, make sure Shaq touches the ball.
Shaq had a little bit of rest because of the foul trouble in the first half. And again, Ben Wallace takes the rebound away.
And he's just quicker to the ball. That's what you keep seeing in this series. The Pistons are just quicker to the basketball.
Prince. Wallace has to come out. Wallace is going to drive all the way. Payton back to the Lakers. Medvedenko. Here's Bryant in the corner. Medvedenko is open from inside the arc and misses.
You notice how Medvedenko came out and he made those three shots. And since then, he has really struggled. He's starting to hesitate. You know, that's the difference between a great player and just an average player. The average player will make a couple, but when he misses, he loses his confidence. A great guy, great player will keep shooting.
Prince short, but again, they keep it alive. And Ben Wallace gets the assist on the Hamilton layup.
That was a great example of what I've been talking about that last play. A loose ball. Shaq reacts, so does Ben Wallace, but Ben Wallace is quicker to the ball.
Now Bryant, and Bryant gets fouled. That one is on Tayshaun Prince. That'll be his first.
I mean, I want you to look at this. You see Shaq and Ben both go to it. Ben gets it quicker, and that causes a layup. Second shot and free throws have killed the Lakers in this series.
Devin George has that swatted out of his hands and out of bounds. 11 on the clock as the Lakers inbound. Medvedenko started 3 for 3. He's now 4 of 8. Payton having trouble getting it in. Just does. Bryant, 7 on the 24. Kobe goes all the way. Left hand stuck.
So Kobe Bryant has come this evening and done what he should do, and that's attack the basket. Shaquille O'Neal getting in foul trouble hurt the Lakers. The key for the Lakers in this half is Shaq staying on the floor.
And playing some defense. Wallace working on Medvedenko. Puts it up.
And there again, I have never seen anybody with the instincts of Ben Wallace. He knows exactly where to be.
And he's quicker than everyone else on the floor.
I mean, how far do you have to go back in the NBA annals, Doc, to think of a guy who knew exactly where to be like that?
Dennis Rodman.
Yeah, you'd have to go back that far, I guess. Well, I was hoping you'd go back to, you know, like Arnie Rison or somebody. Here's Devin George. Hacked out. George sending it around the rim, a 360. The Lakers with a fresh 24 as O'Neal with Wallace on him. Turns on him. Puts it up. Doesn't get the bounce, but gets fouled. And that one on Rasheed Wallace is his third.
And you can see this here. What they're saying is Rasheed Wallace hit with his arms and his body. I think Rasheed Wallace is thinking right now, I think I was hit with Shaq's body and arms.
Shaq, one out of four. He has 9 points in the game. Now one out of five from the free throw line. Lakers have taken 14 free throws tonight, made nine. Pistons 18 and made 14. Misses two here, and Larry Brown saying before the game, we got to beat him at the foul line. But tonight they're beating him from the foul line and from the open court.
Oh,
beautiful pass to Hamilton, and then Devin George comes in for the foul.
What a great cut by Rip Hamilton. He created the entire play with his movement. I mean, just take a look. Watch him start it out. He goes over. He changes speed. He stops. Peyton goes over top. He back cuts, and he gets to the bucket. I tell you, he's the guy that you would not enjoy guarding. He's like a hyperactive kid. Ridland.
Yeah. The medicine cabinet, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like a parent chasing a precocious.
Exactly.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
You can take them to the doctor, but in the NBA, you can't.
Right. 12-point lead. Now 13, 8:25 remaining in the third. When the Pistons have a double-digit lead, they're as tough as anybody to beat because of their great defense. And then Bryant loses it on his way to the basket and looks back at Joey Crawford, the referee. Three-pointer coming up for Hamilton, rimmed it out. Peyton has 2 points tonight. George passes up for three, sends it into Shaq, and he has the easy layup. O'Neal now goes into double figures with 11 points.
You know, it's an 11-point game. And now I get the sense that the Lakers are still in this game.
Doc, my sense is 3 months ago they'd really be in the game, but I'm not sure right now. And a 24-second violation. I say that only because of the dominance of the Pistons in the series. The Lakers keep living on the edge. They've taken themselves right to the precipice right now. Phil Jackson has to mix and match and play a makeshift lineup. And Larry Brown is making all the right calls.
Well, you really have. But when you look at this game right here, I'm looking at the way the Lakers are playing. They look like they're aggressive. They're taking it to the bucket. They're drawing fouls in the half. They might have a chance to get in penalty first in this quarter, which would be different. I tell you, this game is becoming really dangerous for the Pistons.
They called that on Rasheed Wallace. You saw Ben Wallace put his arm up as if to say, call it on me. And they've called it on Rasheed, so that's four on him.
Because it was on Rasheed. And what Ben Wallace was trying to do was sell to his team or to the refs that the foul was on me.
No
sale. So this is the first time now that Rasheed Wallace has gotten in trouble in the second half.
Right. So he picks up his fourth with 19 minutes and 5 seconds remaining in the game. And O'Neal picks a pretty good time for the Lakers to make both. Single digits down, 9-point game. Double teamed in backcourt. And the Devin George runs away and goes, come on, we had him. They call it on George. And Billups goes down as George picks up his third foul.
You know, it's funny. Billups looks down and said he slipped on the play, yet the foul was called already.
Phil Jackson has never lost 3 playoff games in a row. They'll have to pull one out here to keep the series alive. Hamilton. Ben Wallace went high in the air. Prince couldn't put it in, and O'Neal fights for the rebound and has it, and the foul is called on Tayshaun Prince.
And now the Lakers are starting to amount the fouls. They're going to have a chance to be in penalty.
That's 4, so 1 more, and the Lakers will go to the line for the rest of the quarter. 6.5 to play. Payton, little fall away, doesn't go. Ben Wallace with the rebound.
That used to be Payton's staple move. And you can see most of those shots now are front of the rim, which indicates tired legs. And guard Rip Hamilton will do that.
Hamilton can't get there, but Campbell does.
Rip Hamilton calls that play with the dribble penetration.
O'Neal. Ben Wallace cleans the glass again. 10 rebounds for Wallace.
And that was not a good possession for the Lakers.
Prince. Wallace is going to drive and gets fouled. We'll go to the line when we come back on the other end of this break. The Pistons up by 11 at Auburn Hills.
Smile is gonna make you. We gotta fight the powers that be.
What's cold? Cool as life, fast breaks and steals. What's cold? 3-on-1, that's when the game get real. What's cold? Slapping backboards, dunking and breaking glass. No look passes, throwing elbows and talking trash. If you weak, then have a seat. You need to get off the court. Life's cold, but ain't no place for you in this here sport. Ice cold, frostbitten and shivering. It's cold like that, and you could either watch it or live it.
Unleash the Rocky Mountain cold taste of Coors Light.
This Wednesday, Walt Disney Pictures invites you.
Prepare for takeoff.
On the most hilarious, exciting, and best vacation you'll take with your family this summer.
Watch out on the right. Oh, no, my right.
Stop helping me!
Disney's Around the World in 80 Days, rated PG.
Do you have the right truck? The best-selling half-ton regular? And extended cab? Is now available as a crew cab. It's got more standard horsepower, more torque, and more towing capacity than Ford or Dodge half-ton crews. Introducing the new Silverado half-ton crew. It's the right truck from Chevy.
You're driving along. A car pulls in front of you. Another pulls alongside. When the guy up front stops short, you rear-end him, just like he wanted. It's called a swoop and squat. And fraud like this can add hundreds of dollars a year to your insurance bills. It's why Allstate has a dedicated fraud team to track down criminals. Fighting fraud helps keep your insurance affordable. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
Pandora Tomorrow. From the files of Tom Clancy comes a breakthrough action experience. Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. Pandora Tomorrow on PlayStation 2, June 18th, rated T for Teen.
This copyrighted telecast of the National Basketball Association may not be retransmitted, reproduced, rebroadcast, or otherwise distributed or used in any form without the express written consent of the NBA.
The NBA Finals on ABC, brought to you by Coors Light. Unleash the Rocky Mountain cold taste of Coors Light. Nike. And Walt Disney Pictures. Around the world in 80 days starts tomorrow.
Aerial coverage tonight provided by the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company with new Assurance tires. Down at the Palace, NBA Finals MVP. You at home can be part of the process. There's the deal, 622 on your Verizon wireless phone. Crowd got into it with Jack Nicholson. They would show him and then Kid Rock on the other hand. Yay, boo, and all that stuff.
He might be the coolest celebrity on the circuit.
Jack? Had a lot of practice.
Yes, he has.
And he's a great guy.
Now, I'm looking at the Laker lineup. Phil Jackson told us one of the things that he might do is go small. And I think he used the word ultra small, and he's done it. Bryon Russell right now is in the game at the power four position.
Michelle, what went on in the huddle?
Well, a couple things. Phil Jackson came right to the guys and said, you cannot give them rebounds. And during the rest of the timeout, he said, we've got to get stops. And he reminded them, we have to play right through the foul calls. Don't throw your arms. Don't shoot looks. Don't talk to the refs. Your only recourse is to play through the fouls. Play defense with your feet, not with fouls, guys.
That's it. You go to the... You go to all of the fuel left in the tank. Bryon Russell in the game. And again, this is where the Lakers have come, in a situation where Malone can't play. In a desperation game, you go to a guy, Bryon Russell, who has played so little over the last 2 months. Bryon drives, jams one home, 10-point game.
Yeah, this is the first time that this Laker team is looking for something.
Phillips open in the corner. Prince misses. Phil Jackson's like a manager in an elimination game in the World Series as Devin George can't hit what would have been a big one, and Wallace gets the rebound. If you're faced with elimination in the World Series, you'll use every pitcher, every player, and Jackson's done that tonight. They have 12 guys. One is in civvies. That's Malone. They've used the other 11. Prince drives, softly throws it in.
I'm watching that possession. The Lakers players didn't know who they had. They got mixed up because no one knew who was guarding who, and that's why Tayshaun Prince got all the way to the basket.
And that's what's going to happen when you play a quintet that has played so little together. O'Neal starts to go to the hoop. Bernie Fryer calls a foul. Even if it's not a shooting foul, they're still in the penalty here.
Look at this. Look at guys running around. They don't know what they had. Two guys runs here. Shaq has to try to help. I mean, in a game like this, when you come off the bench, you must communicate with each other. I have Rasheed, you have him, and you have to play. That didn't happen, and that just gave up 2 points.
And the Pistons, the heavy underdogs before the series, are the team right now playing probably as cohesively as they have all season.
You know, you're right. One of the things I've noticed in this series is whenever you hear a Piston player talk, he knows exactly what he is supposed to do. When you hear a Laker player talk, he sounds like he's guessing and talking about what they should do.
O'Neal missing both free throw attempts. He's 3 out of 10. The Lakers are 11 of 19. Dan Wallace over Bryon Russell.
That's what happens when you go small.
Kobe loses the ball. There's no foul in the lane. Here's Phillips on a drive. Got it. Goes to the line.
Detroit Pistons
are smelling the doting ball, and they're going for it right now.
Shelly Brown. A 17-point lead. O'Neal. Bryant. Give and take with Shaq. Bolton.
Ben Wallace did that on purpose, Al. He knew it was going in. He wants to show the intimidation factor of the Detroit Pistons. This reminds me of Patrick Ewing against Villanova. Just knock it out to scare him. He didn't care.
He got the gong anyway from upstairs. The gong show. Phillips throws the ball away. Phillips is going to contend that it was touched by a Laker.
I thought it was deflected, to be honest.
From our angle.
It really looked like it was deflected.
Ball took an erratic hop. Lakers now, Bryant outside. Peyton has the ball, looks Kobe's way, goes inside to Shaq, slam dunk. 72-59, under 3 to go in the third. Larry Brown a little nervous again.
Well, I think they're going to be nervous until it's all zero on the clock. But right now,
Larry will be, yeah.
Yeah, they're playing good basketball.
Prince.
I'll tell you, Tayshaun Prince has been more aggressive than I've ever seen him. And Devin George has just picked up a technical foul. Terrible time.
In addition to a personal foul. Fourth foul on him. 2:36 remaining in the third. Detroit by 13.
Will you marry me?
Oh, baby, it's beautiful. Oh, I don't know what to say.
I'll tell you what, Pumpkin. Let me take it out for the next 24 hours, see how it feels, and I'll get back to you in the morning.
Every big decision deserves 24 hours. Right now, take the GM 24-hour test drive. We're so sure you'll love it, if you buy a non-GM vehicle, we'll mail you $250. With that much confidence, it's no wonder we're the number one selling car company on the planet.
Think fast. Lamisil AT cures athlete's foot with just 1 week's use. If you use Tenactin or Lotrimin AF, you'll be treated for 4 long weeks. But 1 week with Lamisil AT keeps you athlete's foot free for 3 months. There's no better way to cure athlete's foot.
Everyone dreams of an island getaway. But what if you couldn't get away from the island? Lost, Wednesdays this fall on ABC.
McDonald's NBA Finals summary. O'Neal tonight, 17. Bryant, 18. But the story has been Detroit's defense again. And Ben Wallace with 13 rebounds and 14 points. So he's done it on both ends. The technical foul will come after the personal foul on George. who looks over at Bernie Fryer and gets teed up.
Yeah, and he earned a technical. There's no doubt about it. And right now at this point in the game, when your team is down 13 points, now 14 points, you can't afford to give up any free buckets. I don't think Phil Jackson is real happy about that technical foul. And that's why you see Devin George with that towel and sitting down.
But there's nothing that Phil can do about it at this point. He's done all of the politicking and all of the carrying on, the manipulating that he could. Too late now. Here's Stewart.
Al, Larry Brown is a consummate coach, even with this team dominating the game, a double-digit lead. The last time out, he told these guys, hey, this game is not over. We got to finish this quarter the right way. No wasted possessions, Al.
Here's O'Neal. Can't get it. Larry Brown grew up in a Jewish family. He was born in Brooklyn. He grew up in New York. His mom is 99. And I think his mom taught him, Larry, don't give yourself a Kenahara, which means don't say something prematurely. And so Larry has always lived that way. And Larry right now is not giving himself a Kenahara.
No, he's not. And more importantly, he's making sure that his team knows that Rip Hamilton was hit in the face on that last possession. It was an accident, but he was definitely hit in the face, right in the nose, it looked like, by Gary Payton. Watch the arm down. That's why you wear that mask. It's safer over here, Al.
Doc, it's safer over here than on the bench. That's what I keep telling you. 7 seconds on the timer. Phillips. Here's Campbell free. Got it with O'Neal coming all the way out on him. Campbell went down. He thought he was fouled.
Everything is falling right now.
And a double technical now. Hamilton and Payton carrying on with each other.
Well, that's the next step. You know, when you're getting dominated, the next step is to try to do other things. Verbally get into it. See if you can throw them off this way, because no other way has worked thus far. And I love what Larry Brown is doing. He's going to take Rip Hamilton off the floor because he wants him to get it together. And he's thinking, listen, this game is not over.
Lindsey Hunter comes into the game. Kobe Bryant will bring the ball up the floor. Bryant, 18 points tonight, 6 out of 15 from the field. O'Neal into the corner. Three-pointer here. Russell misses. Lakers keep it alive. Payton. Fox now. Shaq works it back out. Payton tries for a three. Nothing drops. Prince gets the rebound.
See, that's a sign of desperation. You have guys who could have chosen to put the ball on the floor. Now they're trying to catch up with the three-pointer. That is not going to get the Lakers back in this game. The Detroit Pistons are playing the right way. They just continue to execute their offense, move the ball, be patient, and get their shots. And they're killing the Lakers defensively right now with their offense.
Fox picks up his first foul. The Pistons this season holding 11 opponents in the regular season under 70 points. Fisher comes back in. In Larry Brown's 20-year career, coming into the season, his teams have held opponents under 70 a total of 10 times. He did it more in 1 year than in 20 years.
It's been one of the more dominating defensive performances of all time. And in the playoffs, maybe of all time.
And their backs were to the wall in the Jersey series. And they came back to win 6-7. Bryant from
another three. That's the third straight three.
Now Bryant will drive. Hang in the lane. Nothing goes. And Ben Wallace with the rebound.
The Lakers have the look of this. We tried. We couldn't do it. We're not good enough. And now you can see them slowly deteriorating in front of your eyes.
Kobe Bryant with the foul.
But I got to make the point again. this is not the Lakers playing poorly. This is the Detroit Pistons playing great. It's a big difference.
As we said at the top of the show, when you have an upset of this magnitude, people say, well, how did they do it? And normally, you know, it's whether it's baseball or hockey or basketball or football, there's always, you know, something that happens. You get a break, the ball bounces the right way, the goalie makes a stop. But with the Pistons, it's just that, as we said at the beginning, they're playing better. They're the better team. Bryant, missing. Campbell. Phillips.
Look at the ball movement. Look at the patience. Everybody's touching the ball, even on a fast break.
And the Pistons right now look like a fresh horse. Well-rested, running, flying down the floor, and the Lakers look like they're totally innovative. Wallace has 10 rebounds in this quarter. He has 15 in the game.
You know, every single day there's been a different guy. Chauncey Billups was dominant in one game. Rip Hamilton was dominant in one game. Rasheed Wallace was dominant in one game. And now tonight is Ben Wallace. You know, when you start thinking about MVP, I don't know if you can give it to one person. I think this should be a team MVP. I don't know if that's possible, but you have to think about it.
They've got to give it to an individual according to the rules that I'm aware of.
Change the rules.
Yeah. Give it to a coach, too.
Yeah, they could. They really could.
Fourth foul on Couture. O'Neal at the line is 3 out of 10. Stewart, yours.
How rookie Hamilton just came back in the game. You saw him. He caught that blow to the face. But that face guard he's wearing, it's worth $2,500. The reason he's wearing it, he's broken his nose twice this year already. The doctor said if he has another one, he'd have to miss the rest of the season. What happens when he gets hit, all of the brunt of the blow goes against the forehead and the chin. So he is okay.
Wow. Coast to coast with no one stopping the ball. Before this series, we said if the Lakers didn't play defense, they would not win this series. The Lakers have not played defense.
And it's so loud, and they're so inexperienced as a unit out on the floor, they couldn't even get a shot away at the end of three. Detroit on top, 82-59. The whole Brown family. Brother Herb in the middle, Shelly at the bottom. And the Pistons are 12 minutes away from a title.
Let's play.
The number one action movie in America is The Chronicles of Riddick. It's pure adrenaline, a high-powered adventure, a visual thrill. One of the best sci-fi films ever. The Chronicles of Riddick, rated PG-13.
Sport is sport. A foul's a foul. And a bat's a bat, even if it's flat. 10 feet on the west side is 10 feet on the east side. Football is football. Unless it's football. Now, a win's a win. A loss is a loss. But no matter what, you better come with it. Because it's 90 feet to first. No matter where home is.
When it's variety you crave, try Subway's low-fat or carb-controlled creations. And now, introducing the new Atkins-friendly turkey and ham wrap. Stuffed with fresh veggies and Monterey cheddar, this is how you eat fresh. Subway, eat fresh.
OnStar-equipped 260-horsepower SRX V6 performance SUV. Cadillac. Breakthrough.
Everyone dreams of an island getaway. But what if you couldn't get away from the island? Lost, Wednesdays this fall on ABC.
Guys, where are we?
I love everybody at Action News.
I love Jim Gardner.
Jim Gardner.
Jim Gardner, yeah, he's the man.
He just tells it the way it is.
He's trustworthy, believable.
Has integrity, honesty.
Seems like he cares.
Anytime Jim Gardner says it, you know it's true.
He's a very polite man.
Jim has personality.
He's the voice of Philadelphia.
I do trust him.
Jim is the man. That's what I say. Jim, you the man.
I thought I was the man.
Jim Gardner is a very intelligent man.
Watch Jim Gardner at 6 and 11, only on Action News.
And Jim is handsome.
What's that?
Jim is handsome.
Toyota has some of the most fuel-efficient SUVs on the road.
Good mileage means money, money, money.
I go to the woods for some peace.
Go to the bank, go to yoga, go pick up the kids, go in the grocery.
You'll like Highlander with the lowest fuel costs in its class.
Nice.
And now with third row seating.
I've hauled 6 ballerinas in my car.
I've hauled 30 pumpkins.
And at 30 miles per gallon, RAV4 has the lowest fuel costs in its class.
The road to happiness.
Yeah.
It's coming, the Sunoco Welcome America Celebration.
If you watch right now, Al, if you watch the body language, the movement, who do you think is winning and losing right now? The way the Pistons are playing, if you turn the game on right now, you would think, boy, they must be down. They're playing desperate.
But they've been playing at the same pace. They have controlled the pace. And it's the Lakers who look always a step behind. Kobe goes to the hoop and gets fouled in the lane. Wallace. For Larry Brown, trying to become the first guy to do that. He won the NCAA crown at Kansas in 1988. Danny Manning was his key guy. He also coached UCLA to the national championship game in 1980.
He was here with the Philadelphia 76ers in the NBA championship. Larry Brown, everywhere he's gone, his team has improved. The San Antonio Spurs.
He normally takes reclamation projects. I mean, this is a guy who got the Los Angeles Clippers into the playoffs.
Hey, hey, hey. I was part of that team.
I knew you were. Despite Doc Rivers being on the roster.
He did it in sweater.
Ben Wallace. He'll tip it back in himself over Brian Cook.
This has been a dominating performance this entire series. And you're right, Al. You can make the point that the Lakers are very lucky to be playing tonight.
You get the feeling, the way this is going, that these teams could play 10 more games and the Lakers might not win one. I mean, it's been that dominant.
Look at this.
To rush. Hamilton on Fisher. It's almost like the party has started with 10:32 still left in the game.
Yeah, the party has started. There is no doubt about it. Every long rebound, a Piston releases and gets a fast break. And it's been one-on-one fast break basketball for the Pistons. And I said fast break basketball for the Pistons. The party has started.
Doc coach ever hired under 60 years old. You know, when you think about what's happened since 2000, Dick Vermeil at 63 became the oldest coach to win a Super Bowl. Scotty Bowman, 68, the oldest coach to win a Stanley Cup. He only won 9. Jack McKeon, 72, won the World Series last year. And Larry Brown, who looks about 50 but is 63 years old, is on the verge of becoming the oldest to win an NBA title.
Well, all I have to say is I hope I don't have to wait 23 years to win a title.
Doc will keep this season warm for you, baby. Kobe goes. Oh, and Kobe's hurt. Bryant, this season, of course, in addition to Colorado, was also hurt on a couple of occasions, missed about 15 games. At one point, it looked like he wrenched his shoulder to the point he'd be out for a couple of months. Instead, he was only out for a week or so.
Yeah, I think he missed one game.
Yeah.
It's still not healed. You know, when you talk to the team doctors, he may have to have surgery. They don't know after the season is over. The team is definitely going to have surgery.
The team is going to have major surgery. Talking to Mitch Kupchak, the general manager today, as Wallace comes back in. Hunter goes out. There will be no offseason for the Laker brass. And what about Phil? And what about Shaq? Now, Shaq's under contract. So yeah, unless they trade him,
which will not happen ever.
But they won't trade him?
I don't see that ever happening. I think the number one thing is what Phil Jackson does. Number two is what Kobe does. And you can put that one or two any way you want it. And then it gets down to Karl Malone and Gary Payton and what they do. And then it gets to Kupchak. And what is he going to do to change this basketball team?
Prince. And that's without even mentioning the most important matter in Kobe's life.
Yes.
I mean, it's all moot unless he's acquitted.
You know, the
but
first
Malone, too.
Yeah, Karl Malone, Gary Payton. Wow. The first thing that stands out watching this Lakers team play, you know, it was nice getting Karl Malone, and it was nice getting Gary Payton. But what this team needs is outside shooting in the worst way, because the Detroit Pistons have been able to sag and clog up the paint and haven't had to pay a penalty for it. So I think what you'll see with Mitch Kupchak is they're going to go out and search for shooters.
They got sporadic outside shooting this season, i.e. Fisher. Rasheed misses a three and rushes big game, but not consistently. 8:41. It's on ice. In the back, as Detroit leads by 25. In a Gatorade bucket. Go figure.
You know that race for president of beers?
Yeah.
Miller had to drop out. They're disqualified.
Why?
Well, as it turns out, Miller was bought by South African breweries.
Mm-hmm.
And you would have to be American to run for president of beers.
Oh, well, that's too bad. Yeah. Miller ran all those commercials for nothing, huh?
What a shame.
Yeah.
But the spokesperson, he found a new job.
Oh, yeah? What's he going to do?
He's hosting a reality show called Shoes and Socks.
Oh, he should go far with that.
You're such a mystery.
If you knew who he was, would you tell me?
There are bigger things happening here than me and you.
Tell everyone to hang on!
She can never know the truth, because the ones I love will be the ones who pay.
Let's see who's behind the mask.
Your story continues June 30th. Rated PG-13.
The 265 horsepower Nissan Maxima.
this emphasized. Guns, hookers, and murder.
Bumble.
And that's all before breakfast. Buckle up for NYPD 24-7.
Good job, brother.
Starting next Tuesday, the real NYPD. NYPD 24-7. Next Tuesday at 10, 9 Central.
It must have been at about 40,000 feet.
From the creator of Alias.
Tori.
48 survivors.
Get her out of there!
1,000 miles off course.
They're looking from the wrong place.
Zero chance of rescue.
What was that?
Did anybody say that?
The only way to survive is to escape. Lost. ABC Wednesdays this fall.
Guys, where are we?
Aerial coverage tonight being provided by Goodyear as you look down upon what from that angle is a very plastered round palace of Auburn Hills just sitting out there in the middle of a parking lot.
It looks calm.
Yeah. Inside, a different story. We're talking about the Lakers. Phil Jackson, the first guy they have to talk about. Brian Payton, Malone, and Fisher can opt out. Payton can opt to stay. I mean, he's already under contract, so it's his call there. Fox maybe retires. You don't know the other guys with expiring contracts.
You know, Phil Jackson said something interesting, because all along, I have told you and I believe that he would not come back. You asked him this morning if they lost, would that change his decision? And he said, yes, it probably would.
Yeah.
That makes you think if they lose, which they are going to, he may come back and try to get this right. That surprised me.
As you know, though, in every sentence, you know, Phil goes from here to there. You know, he's like Enya.
I still
moonlight on the ocean is swept around, or whatever the lyrics are. But it's like you walk away and you go, huh?
I still think he quits this year. I don't think he retires, though. I do believe we'll see him coach again, but not with the Lakers again.
Here's O'Neal. You know, Phil, he understands he had a chance here to become the winningest coach, not only in NBA history in terms of championships, but eclipse all other coaches and managers in the four major sports. Is it huge to him? I mean, he can live without it, but it was important to him. He made that pretty obvious as we talked to him throughout the course of the season.
It absolutely was. He also said something that surprised me. I didn't know he was keeping count, that they could catch the Celtics in banners.
Yes.
That upset me, too.
Doc, you can do something about it.
Yeah, I'm going to try.
16-14 is the Laker-Celtic rivalry right now, with Boston up by two. Phillips. Using the clock. Meanwhile, on the other side of the coin, Doc, Detroit, a much younger team, and as the Lakers will end their season unraveling in this series, Detroit ends it on a high note, and they just add exclamation point after exclamation point. Ben Wallace. Plenty rebounds for Wallace. Walton missing. So Detroit with a young team, not that they're not going to go out and try to revamp, every team does. I mean, San Antonio won the title last year, changed 6 of the 12. Minnesota had a pretty good year last year, changed 9 of the 12 and got better.
Well, you know, the difference here is that Joe Dumars has done such a great job. If this goes in, my goodness. I mean, we would have had to leave the building.
Doc, the crowd is already wrung out.
Yes. But Joe Dumars has done such a great job with this team. He's not going to have to make a lot of changes. You know, they have to sign Rasheed Wallace, which I think they will. The mimic Okur is going to be a big thing, whether they can keep him or not. Other than that, this team will look very much the same. And don't forget about the rookie that didn't play this year. He will be a factor in the near future for this Pistons team.
Darko Milicic, what you're talking about?
You know, I couldn't remember his name because he hadn't played all year.
Well, there he is. We just call him Darko, yeah.
The one thing he has to remove is those band-aids from his ear. He was piercing his ear. In the Eastern Conference Finals, they got infected. So now he has to walk around with band-aids on his ear. So He has to learn some things, there's no doubt about it.
He needs a valet is what he does. Or a good girlfriend.
You know, Larry Brown said something really interesting about him. You know, he's so young, he's only 18 years old. Does he know how important a world championship is? He said he might know more about the World Cup than the world championship.
It's Gene Wallace on a turnaround.
But I'm going to say this again. I look at this Detroit Pistons team. Chauncey Billups was given up on. Ben Wallace was said that he couldn't be a factor. Rip Hamilton have been moved. Rasheed Wallace, they remind you of the Oakland Raiders. You know, Joe Dumars has looked at guys of castaways and have put them together and has turned this group into a terrific team.
Rasheed being one of the guys. I mean, he was the walking technical foul, but he's been a choir boy in the playoffs and a very positive influence for this team and a guy Brown wanted, and Dumars as well. Larry's still coaching every possession. He's the coach's coach.
You want another bud?
No, thanks.
Oh, gotta take this. Watch my beer.
I'd like to see what's going on under that label of yours. Sometimes when I'm drinking my bud, I pretend it's you with all that flavor. You know, a lot of guys don't understand cold filtering.
What's up, Kenny?
But I know how smooth you are. I'm breaking it off with my beer for you. Maybe I'll just take a little taste right now and leave it. What?
The world is talking about the Nissan Titan. Four Wheeler Magazine says. Sport Truck Magazine proclaims
Sport Truck of the Year.
Trailer Post Magazine raves
Joe's Eagle of the Year.
Automobile Magazine declares
All-Star,
hey.
All-Star.
Talking about the mighty Titan.
Built in America, yeah.
Nokia, connecting people.
Mom, Dad, Kyle said that he took a hold of China.
I got this one.
Now, the Earth's diameter is 8,000 miles.
8,000 miles of digging?
Whoa, he couldn't get through all the magma.
China? No way.
Any holes in China?
Oh, Kyle.
Life's better with the butterfly. Come see all the ways you can get more done at MSN.com.
I'm Jim Gardner. An explosion and four-alarm blaze leaves part of a Camden apartment complex in ruins. More heavy rain sends local creeks over their banks. AccuWeather has the latest. And Mideast kidnappers release video of a captive New Jersey man. Next.
The NBA Finals on ABC. Brought to you by Miller. Vote Miller for President of Beers. Good call. Nissan, who invites you to shift the way you move through the world.
Ben, we throw to you. Just get it down and get it our play. You gotta use clock. I wanna run every time. But we don't have the break, we gotta use clock. They can't get a second shot.
That's a man who has a championship wrapped up, Doc, in the fourth quarter of Game 5, coaching every possession.
And you know it's awesome to watch him because obviously he wants to win the championship, but he's so much about the game of basketball. He's a teacher. He wants him to play the right way all the time. He's going to coach until 0-0-0-0 is on the clock.
Rushed. I'll tell you a guy getting a big kick out of this right now. Dean Smith.
I'll tell you another one. Fred Auerbach.
Yes. Red's lighting up a cigar.
If you don't follow basketball, you just watch. Red Auerbach's record was in jeopardy. Red is a very proud man.
Yes, he is.
Red loves that record. And Red and Phil have had long-distance barb cuts. On the other hand, we're talking about Larry Brown playing for Dean Smith, North Carolina. I've known Dean for all of those years, in contact with him all the time. Never calls him Dean. That's the coach.
Yes.
Doc, can I call you next year, like during the week, and you can give me some lines and I can read them on the air?
Anytime. And I'll be watching you, I'll tell you that.
Shaq on the bench. Dean Smith. Dean Smith and John Wooden, of a kind, of course.
Look at that.
In college basketball annals. The young Larry Brown. People forget Larry Brown was a hell of a basketball player.
He really was.
And for Larry, the negatives to Larry, and there are some people who don't like him because he's moved around so much in Philadelphia, some fans felt he deserted him. Larry does have a little wanderlust in him. There's no question about it. It's maybe the pursuit of perfection as Cook makes that shot. It could be a lot of different things. But he is a guy, as his brother Herb said to me the other night, you know, we'll be driving around. He'll see kids playing on a playground. He wants to get out of the car and coach them.
No doubt. You know, when I was with the Clippers and Larry Brown coached me, we would play one-on-one games after practice. Larry would come back out on the floor and stop us because we didn't pivot the right way. So we left practice and we went somewhere else to play the game.
Crowd looking for 100, and they're going to get it sooner or later because they still have 3:44 to play. And of all crazy things in this series, could you have ever figured Detroit would win in a blowout? The Lakers would need a near miracle to win the only game they win, and Detroit would wind up in triple figures in a blowout deciding game.
You know, Al, I'm going to go back to our first game here. And we said in the series that if the Detroit Pistons scored 90, between 85 and 90 points, they would win because they will never give up 90 points. I'm looking up at the scoreboard right now. The Pistons have 98 points, and the Lakers have 72. So as great as the Detroit Pistons defense has been, it's still been about the Lakers not playing defense in this series, or maybe not able to play defense because everyone underestimated the Pistons' offense.
They know now. You saw Shelly Brown. Shelly and Larry will get about 11 minutes to exult. Larry's going to coach the Olympic team.
Yeah.
So he's going to go into a draft situation next week with this team. He's going to have a parade and all of that. Then he's got to start getting the Olympic team together. Then they have a camp. Then they go to Germany to play. Then they go to Athens, of course, for the Olympics. And he comes back and he plays about two rounds of golf and he goes back to training camp.
Yeah, and they're in another, as Shaq called it, a half-team situation. And, you know, an H-A-F-T-O situation. Because he had to get this team to the finals after they made the switch to Rick Carlisle. Now he's taking the dream team and he has to win the gold medal.
2:56 remaining in the fourth. We're counting down to a celebration in Motown. NBA Finals on ABC Sports.
No power, no plugs, no wires. perfect place to connect. Because with a laptop powered by Centrino, Intel's mobile technology, you can put on quite a show wirelessly from your own private amphitheater. Intel Centrino mobile technology.
Let's play. When the battles begin, you never know where the heroes will come from.
NBA Finals, Sunday night on ABC. The Chronicles of Winning, EPS June 11th.
Taco Bell's new Ranchero Chicken Soft Taco. Marinated grilled all-white meat chicken, freshly prepared fiesta salsa, and a zesty avocado ranch sauce. So much great taste, you'll be floored by flavor. For a burst of fresh flavor, think outside the bun.
Who was it that declared Budweiser the king? Everyone who's ever opened one. Around the corner, around the world.
For these lawyers, the best defense is offensive.
I've told you like sicko perverse sexual deviants.
It's not that I like them so much as I am one. Bad
of the ball. James Spader and William Shatner. How bad can they be? Fleet Street, ABC Sundays this fall.
Here at the Palace with a reminder you can vote for the NBA Finals MVP by sending the text message NBA to the number 622 using your Verizon wireless phone or log on to NBA.com. You better hurry because the MVP will be announced in the trophy presentation, which comes up right after the game. Byron Scott, Tom Tolbert, who's the MVP?
I think Chauncey Billups is MVP, hands down.
And I think if there were ever a year you'd want to give the MVP to an entire team, this would be it, Chauncey Billups.
The Patriots coming out before the Super Bowl will be out on the floor for the trophy presentation, the MVP presentation, as the champagne is on ice and about ready to be opened. First Pistons championship won here in Detroit, Al.
Okay, Mike, and it's well put about the MVP. There is no clear-cut guy. I'd vote for Billups, too. I think he's been phenomenal. Ken Wallace has been fantastic tonight.
Yeah, you know what? It's such a tough vote. And I'm going to vote for Ben Wallace because this team is all about defense, and he's the anchor. And even though Billups has had better offensive games, Ben Wallace has been a factor throughout this series with his presence, and I think I have to go with him.
This is the kind of election that's so close, there'll be a bunch of dangling chads at the end of it. This is no clear-cut guy.
It should be a team MVP.
And we talked about it on the pregame show, Doc. When you think about these Pistons, there won't be one guy who comes to mind. You'll think about a collection of guys. It won't be Michael Jordan's Bulls or Shaq and Kobe's Lakers or Duncan and Robinson's Spurs. This is different.
It is.
Actually, it's refreshing, too.
Yeah, you could vote for Joe Dumars. I mean, the trade before the trade deadline, bringing Rasheed Wallace to the Pistons swung the title to the Pistons.
That is, I'm thinking about that. You're right.
Yeah.
You are right.
And now I got to tell you, this has been a great year for me. I'm trying to stay composed. I really am. I've been a player, I've been a coach for Celtics, and now I can say that I've done the NBA Finals with Al Michaels, Michelle Tafoya, and Chris Scott, and Al, this is so amazing for me. It's been amazing. It's been awesome.
Doc, you're so kind as Tayshaun French comes off, and Larry will bring the guys off one by one. Doc, I look at it this way. The way you started in Orlando, we had to get you off the street.
Yes, you did.
And I had a blast this year with you.
Thank you very much.
Kobe Bryant, there's Chauncey Billups, Okur. Larry Brown doing everything he can now to get everybody to come off the floor as they reach triple figures. Get the individual acclaim. And why not? The Pistons are going to wind down the playoffs with some good defensive play. Their trademark, their hallmark.
those quick hands. James, Darko.
I think he'll get the rest of the shots. The rest of this game.
Fisher makes it from outside. So this Piston team, which has really captured this area, and they love this style of play. So Hockey Town USA is going to become Hoops Town USA in about a minute and 12 seconds.
But you know, it's such a blue-collar team that fits this city. All you heard from them is punching the clock, you know, one more shift, paycheck time. I mean, this is such a blue-collar basketball team. And that you can make the case like the Lakers and, you know, the L.A. Lakers fit L.A. This Detroit Pistons team really fits the city.
Hamilton can take that mask off for the final time. Rasheed Wallace is going to win his first title. What a bizarre... Just a bizarre end of the list. I'm looking at the shots. Bryant, O'Neal, Jackson, Malone in street clothes, Payton. And of all crazy things, this team, which always seems to come up with the clutch play or the divine play when they needed it, will end it like this.
Well, they lived on the edge, Al. And against the Detroit Pistons, you can't live that way. I will say this. It would be ironic if Karl Malone ends his career in street clothes, since he played every game for the most part his entire career.
Sure. And if Phil Jackson ends his career losing for the only time in the finals, yeah, he'll be 9-1 here.
You know what I love, though? When they signed Karl Malone and Gary Payton, everybody assumed that, well, they just have won a title. If you're a team sport guy, it gives every kid in the world a message. No matter who's on your team, you still have to earn it. And that's what this title was all about.
We started the first game. I said to you, you know, you have to run the race. You got to play the game. The day before, Birdstone had beaten Smarty Jones. We said that the Pistons have a better chance to beat the Lakers than Birdstone had.
He's still running.
They're going to win the middle three games, something that no team has done at home since they went back to a 2-3-2 format in 85. There was actually a time in the mid-50s, believe it or not, when a home team won all three games in the middle. It was the Pistons. They were in Fort Wayne, but of all crazy things, they played those games in Indianapolis and beat the Syracuse Nationals.
And the last team to win an Eastern champion, and he was from the East, without Phil Jackson being involved, with the Detroit Pistons in 1990.
Rick Fox ending the game, hunched over his former teammate Lindsey Hunter and congratulating him as the clock ticks down. And the Detroit Pistons, wow, who won the NBA championship in 89 and 90, and the crazies just have to stop blowing up stuff in indoor buildings,
yes,
before we have a disaster. Thank you, Commissioner. But the Detroit Pistons have just shocked the Los Angeles Lakers. 100-87 to win the NBA title. The number two seed in the Eastern Conference. And for the Lakers, it truly will be the end of a particular era. They've had the three championships. They brought in the other guys. We talked about how much they'll revamp. For Joe Dumars, who was selected by Bill Davidson to run the team, he can exult. Bill Jackson will contemplate his future, and we'll talk about that very shortly, I'm sure, in the next couple of days as the confetti rains down at the Palace of Auburn Hills. Chauncey Billups, a likely candidate for the MVP award. And the Detroit Pistons, this gritty, gutty, defensive-oriented team, plays phenomenally on both ends of the floor and beat the Lakers in five. Shelly Brown, like a lot of
coaches' wives, a lot of different homes. You've got to keep the family together. And this was a very rough year for Larry because his family was settled in Philadelphia, the kids in school. He's trying to fly back on off days, living in an apartment. Back and forth they go. For Kobe Bryant, the biggest of question marks, of course, for him.
Yes.
And so you, the complete contrast and evidence here as the game is over.
Well, you just look at this entire season, and these Detroit Pistons teams always believed that they could. They played the same way all year, and you knew every time you played this team that they were going to come out and play hard, play great defense, and as we've said 100 times now, play the game the right way. There's a lot of people smiling at this basketball team.
Stuart Scott.
Tayshaun Prince, you guys did something that nobody outside your locker room thought you would. It wasn't just that you beat them, but how? What did you all know that nobody else did?
We just took it to them, man. We knew we could play with everybody in this league. And I think we showed it today, but obviously they came out, gave it everything they have, and we just kept fighting. We kept fighting, and it was just an all-around effort by everybody today.
Everybody in your locker room was concerned about one thing coming into this game, not to get so uptight that you try to do too much individually. How did you blow them out like this?
This is a situation where it was like a last game for them. We said the same thing for us. This is the last game. Look at it, us being down 3-1. We took it.
We haven't seen you smile the entire series, man. Give me one.
You know what? I'm feeling so happy right now. It's all inside, but, man, I can't even feel it. I can't even explain it right now.
One of your teammates said once that you don't have a pulse. I see your pulse and your heart. Congratulations, Tayshaun.
Thank you.
Let's go back to Al.
All right, thank you, Stuart. Coming up will be the trophy presentation. Bill Davidson will get another precious piece of hardware. We'll also find out who the MVP is. Larry Brown finally wins an NBA title in his 21st season. 187 Detroit. Stick around.
And Sony Connect are hooking up for the greatest music deal in history. Every time you buy a Big Mac meal, you get a free song. Just go to connect.com to get your access to hundreds of thousands of hot tracks.
SUV, the QX56. Surround yourself with refinement, entertainment, and comfort for seven. From Infinity.
The NBA believes that reading is the foundation to a child's future. And when you develop a lifelong love of reading, anything is possible.
How does a dinosaur say goodnight when Papa comes in to turn off the light?
Whether it's one book, one child, or one relationship at a time, the teams and its players are strengthening ties with their communities and building a brighter future for everyone. So open a book and read to achieve.
There's a chant around town that goes, Detroit basketball. And the guy who originated it is the PA announcer here. He'll take us to the ceremony, Mason.
And now, Piston fans, the Larry O'Brien Trophy.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you, I guess, the ad-
address has changed here. This is now 4 Championship Drive in Auburn Hills, Michigan. Here to present the Larry O'Brien Trophy to the world champion Detroit Pistons, the commissioner of the NBA, David Stern.
Against the celebrated and valiant effort by the Los Angeles Lakers, your Detroit Pistons demonstrated that fairy tale endings do actually occur in sports, as rare as they may be. Against all expectations, but because of hard work, very hard work, and teamwork, I'm delighted to congratulate Bill Davidson, the owner of the Pistons. Tom Wilson, Joe Dumars, particularly Coach Larry Brown, and of course, the city of Detroit, who believed in this team. And this team met their expectations, even though no one else expected it. So to your 2004 NBA champion Detroit Pistons, congratulations. And here's the trophy.
Take that, Ben. Mr. Davidson. Now you have the WNBA championship, the Stanley Cup with the Tampa Bay Lightning. I know all the championships mean so much, but I've seen you in the practice facility, seeing these guys. This is your baby. This one has to be super special to you.
Absolutely. It is, and this is the greatest. I always have to be a little careful that I say I like them both equal, but this is a great night, and the guys did a tremendous job.
Congratulations. Bill Davidson, owner of the Detroit Pistons. We have to get Larry Brown over here. Coach Larry Brown. Coach, I know you inherited a very good team, but they did figure out the right way to play. It seemed like the right fit for the coach and the players. Tell us your emotions as your family's here and you finally, after the long journey, become the first man to win an NCAA championship and an NBA championship as a coach.
Well, one, I feel fortunate that I inherited a team that Rick Carlisle coached. He did a great job. I'm sorry Chucky Atkins and Michael Curry and John Barry and Cliff Robinson aren't here to enjoy it. But this is a great team. Mr. D and Joe and the whole staff assembled great guys that do play the right way, and I'm proud to be part of that.
I know there are two people who are watching who you share great emotion for and with. Coach Smith, Dean Smith, your mentor, and your 99-year-old mom who has just watched you and your older brother Herb work together to win an NBA championship. Having your brother here, your mom watching at home, has to be special to you.
Well, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Coach. A lot of us in this profession benefited by being around him. And for my mom, I babysitted my brother long enough, and we finally got it done. I love you, Mom.
Larry Brown, coach of the champion Pistons. Now time for the presentation of the Most Valuable Player Trophy. And once again, Commissioner Stern.
You saw it. 21 points a game, over 5 assists. The 2004 NBA Finals MVP, number one, Chauncey Billups.
You just looked at that and said, wow. After all the places you've been and the expectations when you were drafted high in the draft, all the stops, did you ever stop dreaming that you could find the right place for your talents?
I never stopped dreaming, man. God is good. You know, God is very good. He put me here for a reason, and that's the reason.
You guys were as heavy an underdog as we've seen win the championship in almost a quarter century. I know the guys believed. Tell me why this team was able to overcome the Lakers.
Because we just believe in ourselves, and we play team basketball. We're not just individuals. We got individual good players, but we're a great basketball team, and we know that that can overcome every time.
Congratulations. MVP of the finals, Chauncey Billups. I would imagine you would like to hear from Joe Dumars. Joe Dumars, finals of the NBA MVP of the finals, I should say, joins Jerry West as the only people to be finals MVP and the architect of a championship team. I know it's sweet as a player. Tell me what it's like to be the boss.
It's so much better here. You put your heart and soul into it, and to have this happen is just unbelievable.
Joe, as I said, this team was a heavy underdog. When did you believe this team could do it?
I felt like we could win this thing. I really did. Even before the series started, I thought that we could win. And I knew we were underdogs, but I never thought that these guys were. I just felt like these guys, it was their year to win it.
Joe Dumars and the rest of the world champion Detroit Pistons, ladies and gentlemen. And we send it back to Al Michaels.
All right, thank you, Mike. So Billups wins an MVP award in the finals before he ever makes an all-star team. Who's the last guy to do that? Joe Dumars did it on one of the Detroit championship teams in 90. Just a few moments ago, what's it like on the other side? Michelle talked to Derek Fisher.
Derek Fisher, obviously this is an incredibly emotional time. What is your team going through in that locker room?
Mixed emotions, Michelle, to be honest. Extreme disappointment, but very resilient. I'm so proud of this team. We didn't have to be here. We went through some things that I don't think any other team could have gone through and still gotten to this point. And, you know, we definitely have to tip our hat to the Pistons, no question about that. You have to win graciously and you have to lose graciously. And we're disappointed, but the Pistons were the better team this year.
You guys came into this game saying all the right things, that you believed you could get it done, that you were confident, that you'd been in this position before. What happened out there tonight?
Same things as have been happening this entire series, you know. Second chance points, you know, offensive rebounds, you know, they're beating us to loose balls. You know, I think they wanted it more, you know, collectively as a group. That doesn't take anything away from anybody on our team. I think we wanted it as well, but they were able to take, you know, emotionally what they desired and what they wanted and carry it over to the physical. And we were a step slow too many times, and, you know, they deserve it.
Phil Jackson had said many times this may be a last dance for this particular team. What are your thoughts about the future of this team? How likely is it you'll be together next year?
You know, who knows? You know, the nature of this business has really changed over the years. And, you know, from year to year, when you leave that locker room for the last time, you never know if you're going to see that guy again. And, you know, I think we'll all just, you know, enjoy the time that we have left together tonight and tomorrow on our plane ride back. And, you know, just be thankful that we had this opportunity. A lot of guys haven't had this opportunity. And, you know, we had a chance and we couldn't get it done, but we're thankful.
Derek, classy move to come out here and talk with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Send it back to you.
All right, thank you, Michelle. Kobe Bryant walking off at the end of the game. A sight that not a lot of people expected to see, but Detroit was completely dominant. Winning game 5, 187, and back will come after this.
You've never seen anything like this before. That. This. The new Icy Hot Sleeve.
Introducing the new Icy Hot Medicated Sleeve. A breakthrough in pain relief. The Icy Hot Sleeve surrounds painful joints with concentrated pain relief that goes on icy to dull the pain, then gets hot to relax it away for hours. The new Icy Hot Sleeve. Joint-hugging, stay-put pain relief for elbows, wrists, ankles, and knees.
The new Icy Hot Sleeve. Hard-working pain relief.
You have a secret.
I see dead people.
There is a sole survivor, and he is miraculously unharmed.
There's a monster outside my room.
On July 30th, M. Night Shyamalan takes you into the village, and there is no turning back. Shyamalan's The Village.
The Pistons are the 2004 NBA champions. And now, direct from the NBA store on NBA.com, you can own the Pistons championship pack. The official hat and t-shirt the Pistons wore during their post-game celebration. Plus, relive all the excitement with the NBA Finals DVD, highlighting the 2004 NBA champion Pistons. Log on to NBA.com or call 866-NBA-0823. Get the official hat, t-shirt, and DVD for only $64.99. Celebrate with your 2004 NBA champion Pistons.
Over the last 3 years, the team that represented the Eastern Conference in the NBA Finals have won a total of three games. The Detroit Pistons getting the four here, and Chauncey Billups and Ben Wallace hold the hardware as the Pistons are the NBA champions. Back for final thoughts from Byron Scott and Tom Tolbert with a reminder that your late local news, Nightline, and Jimmy Kimmel Live follow our broadcast. Byron.
Well, clearly Detroit is the better team in this series. I think they've outplayed them all five games. And, this might be the last we see the Lakers as we know it with Karl Malone, Gary Payton. Don't know the uncertainty of Kobe Bryant and also Derek Fisher. So, we saw a great series as far as Detroit is concerned. I think they totally outplayed them.
One thing I want to stop hearing is what happened to the Los Angeles Lakers. I'll tell you what happened to the Los Angeles Lakers. The Detroit Pistons happened to the Los Angeles Lakers. That's what happened. It wasn't anything that Los Angeles didn't do to lose this series. It's what the Detroit Pistons did to win this series.
It just turned after midnight on the East Coast. 146 years ago, now today, June 16th, Abraham Lincoln said, "A house divided against itself cannot stand." That describes the Lakers, and Phil Jackson, just in his press conference 30 seconds ago, said there is a, quote, slim chance he might return next year.
Well, again, like I said, they've had problems all season long, and, this is no surprise to me and probably anybody else in Los Angeles.
This Laker team, as we know it, is done. I mean, not done competing, but done as we know it with the pieces they have in place right now.
Tom, pleasure again, year two.
Yes.
Good luck in New Orleans, Coach.
Mike, always
thanks,
a pleasure.
Thanks, B.
We really enjoyed it. Al Michaels and Doc Rivers will have their final thoughts. Remember to stay tuned for your late local news afterwards, especially here in Detroit, where there'll be a lot of celebrations. The Pistons are the champs. Al and Doc will wrap it up right after this.
Join us all summer long for ESPN 25. Next Tuesday on Who's Number One, we'll count down the worst teams from the 96 Tigers.
All the energy was just sucked out.
To the 1980 New Orleans Saints.
Half of the stands have bags over their head.
And on the headlines, we'll revisit stories from the Tyson conviction.
Oh, yeah, he's nuts. He's insane.
To the Williams sisters' domination.
Those two girls brought tears in my eyes many, many, many times.
Who's Number One and the headlines. Next Tuesday night, 7 Eastern on ESPN.
Next line, please, Jason.
FODPC.
Good. Now the line below it.
DPLTC.
Now the bottom one.
ZOL. Doc, I can't see when you're doing that.
Oh, I'm
CFT. Sorry.
Thanks, Mr. Kidd.
Richard, your car's being towed. What?
What? Oh.
Hey. It's my car.
He was a young boy with a best friend.
Sunga.
Unlike any other.
I see you, Sunga.
But on June 25th...
He's getting too big.
Tiger!
He's about to discover...
Sunga is not dangerous.
The hardest thing about growing up...
Sunga!
...is knowing when to let go.
You must stay in the jungle forever.
Two Brothers, rated PG, starts June 25th.
Some more celebration scenes as the players and coaches and staffs have repaired to the respective locker rooms. The Detroit Pistons have won the gold ball. That promotional campaign was very good, and I guess Ben Wallace wins that. Great spot with him as the barber. You know, Doc, we've both been around sports, and I've covered a lot of sports for a lot of years. In a 9-day period, I can't think of a turnaround like this in such a huge event. I mean, it's almost as if in a World Series or in a Stanley Cup, one team is expected to win, and then not only does the other team win, the other team becomes so dominant that by the end, the underdog looks like it's invincible, and the favorite looks like it can't win a game if he played until August.
And it wasn't just a couple of people. It was most people. I mean, experts, quote-unquote experts, saying five, can it go four? And when you heard that, It was all about can the Pistons win one game? If they won one game, it would be a good series. I mean, this was a dominant performance, and it was a great team performance. Before we go, Al, I want to say that Al Michaels here has just completed the Grand Slam. He's done hockey, basketball, baseball, and football, all the world championships, and that's pretty awesome.
And the world barrel jumping championship.
Yeah. I wanted to leave that part out.
We're not going to put it in there. You know, it was so interesting watching the teams walk off. I mean, the Lakers, and clearly they'll be broken up in some measure to a large extent in all likelihood.
Will.
And then Larry Brown. And, you know, I'm just watching Larry, and he's talking about his 99-year-old mother, and you saw the way he was, and it's never been about Larry. And by the way, I saw his other wonderful moment in life, his only hole-in-one on the golf course, one of five people to beat
yes,
that.
Yes, exactly.
And it's always about the others. And he is so elated for his players, for the coaches that he's worked with, for the kids he's brought along. And I can't think of a guy in that profession more respected than Larry Brown.
Well, he reminds you of the John Wooden of the NBA. I mean, John Wooden was a lot like Larry Brown, that all the titles and all the accomplishments that he had and Larry Brown has, he always talks about the greatness of the players and everybody else around him, almost deflecting what he's done. Larry Brown is a great basketball coach, and he's known around this league as the coach's coach. So it's rare that other coaches, because this is competitive league, but it's rare that other coaches are happy for a coach when he wins a title, but everyone's happy for Larry Brown.
He's helped turn the balance of power a little bit back to the East. You'll keep that going.
Yes.
My man going to the Boston Celtics. Someday again, I'll come out of retirement when you're finished with the Celtics.
Oh, thank you, Al.
Great series. Great work with you, Doc. And a little look at some of the images from this series, beginning in Los Angeles in game one, and the Pistons were able to pull one off, and people were shocked, and then Kobe pulled that one off at the end of regulation. They win in overtime. The Pistons come back. They're supposed to be despondent. They weren't. The Lakers couldn't do anything defensively, and Big Ben was phenomenal, especially at the end, whether it was the Afro or cornrows. So the Lakers are finished. The Pistons have won the title, and that will do it from Auburn Hills. Al Michaels, Doc Rivers, Michelle Tafoya, Stuart Scott, for our entire ABC crew, and they were magnificent. Good night from the home of the world champions, Detroit Pistons.
For these lawyers, the best defense is offensive.
I'm involved.
Anyone I know?
Myself, actually. And it's quite serious.
James Spader, how bad can he be? Fleet Street, ABC Sundays this fall.
There's never been a better time to get into a Jeep Grand 4x4, like Jeep Grand Cherokee. Right now, qualified lessees can get one for just $269 a month and only $999 due at signing. The legendary Grand Cherokee with four-wheel drive, power windows, locks, and air conditioning for just $269 a month. But get in today, because this incredible offer ends June 30th. The best values in America are at your Jeep dealer during June bonus days.
Grab some body wash from Old Spice.
When I walk through a jam, no one knows who I am. Put my love to the test, and I miss the success.
It has a dual-action formula, so you get really clean, smell really great.
Hey, Ben, need help with your anatomy homework?
You!
Now in Mountain Rush Scent, spice things up.
Wouldn't it be great if other games were more like ours, with so many ways to win? Introducing the new Match 6 Lotto from the Pennsylvania Lottery. You can win on one line or by combining lines. And because there are more ways to match, there have already been over 6 million winners. Just check the drawings every Tuesday and Friday. Match 6 Lotto with a starting jackpot of $500,000. Oh, what a game.
Enjoy your new Durango.
Look, it's got a DVD. And see how smooth the ride is for you and Fluffy.
Liz, what are you doing to him?
I'm just showing little Joey the new Durango.
Son, there's only one thing you need to know. Hemi. Can you say Hemi?
Hemi.
That's my boy.
The all-new Dodge Durango. Big size, smooth ride, heavy power. Qualified buyers who finance through Chrysler Financial get an additional $1,000 for a total combined cash allowance of $4,500 on Durango.
It's coming, the Sunoco Welcome America Celebration.
Action News, Delaware Valley's leading news program, with Gary Poffa, Cecily Tynan, and Jim Gardner.
This is the way it looked tonight in the city of Camden. A huge fire consumed an apartment building, and officials say tonight's bad weather may have been the trigger to this destructive blaze. Whatever the cause, the result is clear. Dozens of people have lost their homes. Tuesday night, and the big story on Action News tonight is an explosion and massive fire in the 500 block of North 30th Street. Action News reporter Michelle McCormack has the full story.
Hours after this fire began, firefighters were still dousing hot spots, and a backhoe was brought in to clear away debris. Although there was plenty of lightning at the time this fire started, it's believed high winds and heavy rains actually caused a partial structure collapse, which ruptured a gas line. On a scale of 1 to 10, the fire chief on the scene says the fire at the Stockton Station apartment complex was an 11. The call first came in as a gas leak. There was a detectable odor in the air.
I heard the firemen banging on the doors, and they said, everybody don't turn on the light switch and evacuate the buildings.
Firefighters knew with gas still escaping, an explosion was a real risk, so they established a perimeter. Everyone from the complex was shuttled to safety. A stray cat fended for himself. And while firefighters were hosing down the building as a preemptive strike.
It just exploded. Everything I own, this is it. What I got on, this is it. I have nothing.
With gas still escaping some 2 hours after the original explosion, fire crews knew this was a battle that could not be won at the building where the blaze began. But they did find victory elsewhere.
We had multiple buildings in close proximity to the original fire building and explosion, and no fire damage and no major fire spread has happened to any exposures, which is a real credit to the men.
More than 30 people were displaced by the fire, but only 12 had taken the city up on its offer for shelter at the Perez Center here in Camden. Four people went to the hospital as a precaution, but they are not serious injuries. Some residents say that there had been gas leaks many times before here. However, the fire department says it's no more than usual, and there were no outstanding fire code violations before this fire. However, one source with the department who asked not to be identified said that this apartment complex was falling into disrepair. In Camden, Michelle McCormack, Channel 6 Action News.
Lightning is being blamed for sparking another fire in Camden. This one was contained to the fifth floor of the Parkade building at 5th and Market. Firefighters got it out quickly. Damage was minimal. A fire in the Fultonville section of Philadelphia was also sparked by lightning tonight. Two garages burned in the 4500 block of North Front Street. No injuries were reported in either blaze. The storms also brought heavy rain, which caught a few people off guard. That rain created street flooding in traditional problem areas like here on Lincoln Drive near West Rittenhouse Street. Let's go live outside to meteorologist Cecily Tynan for the latest information from AccuWeather. Cecily?
Well, Jim, it's very muggy out here, but fortunately our weather has definitely settled down. Storm Tracker 6 Live showing not a lot going on. A little bit of light rain generally north of the city, but the thunderstorms have moved out. But Action Radar showing over the past 12 hours, things really firing up, especially between about 6 and 8 o'clock. And now you can see that one thunderstorm cell just kind of falling apart, becoming rain right now. But some areas were hit very hard, especially Lancaster County. A flood warning remains in effect for Lancaster County until 1:15 this morning. They had some pretty heavy downpours. Also, widespread flooding thanks to the downpours in Bart and Coleraine Townships. Bridge roads washed out from the floodwaters and wind damage. One thunderstorm cell had winds up to about 60 miles per hour. That brought down a lot of tree limbs and a lot of wires. Now, Action Radar again showing things have settled down, but the problem is we'll still be in the soupy air mass through the week. Tomorrow, a little bit of a break, but then things could fire up again. I'll have the complete AccuWeather 5-day forecast in a few moments. Jim?
Thanks, Cecily. Chopper 6 was over the scene of a search for a driver who plunged into the Delaware River tonight. It happened off Mill Street in Bristol Borough, Bucks County. Police say a truck drove off a boat ramp into the water at 8:45 tonight. Rescue crews are still at the scene. Islamic militants have threatened to kill New Jersey native Paul Johnson. This video surfaced late today on an Islamic website showing Johnson being held captive 4 days after he was kidnapped in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. His captors say they will kill him unless Saudi authorities release al-Qaeda prisoners. Action News reporter Dan Quayer has the latest from the home of Johnson's sister in Little Egg Harbor Township, Ocean County.
Jim, family members here are really lying low. They don't want to say anything that could somehow jeopardize Paul Johnson's life. Johnson's uncle, however, in carefully measured remarks, was asking people for their prayers.
He don't deserve this. He don't. He's too nice of a man.
A distraught uncle who helped raise Paul Johnson since he was 15, shortly after his father died. It was indeed very distressing for him to see his nephew on that latest videotape released by Al-Qaeda, a tape that appeared to have been heavily edited.
I'm American out of the United States. In the front end of the Apache helicopter, I worked on an Apache helicopter.
A masked gunman identifying himself as Abdul Aziz Al-Magrin then appeared holding an AK-47. He is the self-proclaimed Al-Qaeda leader in Saudi Arabia. Speaking in Arabic, he demanded that Saudi Arabia free Al-Qaeda prisoners and that Westerners leave the country. That if the demands were not met within 72 hours, Johnson would be killed.
He's been a family man and a good one. God be with him. Just please pray for Paul.
As the chilling footage was broadcast throughout the evening, the level of concern in Johnson's hometown grew. A neighbor of Paul Johnson's sister decided to cut her grass because he felt compelled to do something, anything, to help.
I just feel bad. I really feel bad. I don't know what to say.
And to help ease the sense of helplessness and a sign of the desperate tenor the hamlet of West Creek has taken, a prayer vigil was now set for Thursday, the day the deadline is set to end. Johnson's family, indeed, was touched by all the kind acts of their neighbors.
And I want to thank the people of West Creek and the whole area. They've been really supportive. I want to thank yous all. God bless yous.
A sense of the emotion being felt in this close-knit community. They are really hoping against hope that Paul Johnson some way, somehow, gets out of this alive. In Little Egg Harbor Township, New Jersey, Dan Quayer, Channel 6 Action News.
The group allied with Al-Qaeda and headed by Abu Musab al-Zarqawi has claimed responsibility for the car bombing yesterday in Baghdad that killed 13 people. A statement on the internet said that these operations are a clear message to Americans that, quote, your path into Muslim countries will not be as easy as you think. Another issue rising to the surface, transferring Saddam Hussein from American to Iraqi custody. The new Iraqi government wants Saddam on June 30th when sovereignty changes hands, but President Bush refuses to commit to that date.
Well, I just want to make sure that when sovereignty is transferred, Saddam Hussein stays in jail. That's just a matter of discussion and understanding the procedures. That's all we're saying. I'm confident that when it's all said and done, he will stay in jail. I just want to be assured. Listen,
Bush's reluctance to commit on Saddam is raising some new questions about the degree of Iraqi authority after June 30th. Meanwhile, the attacks against two Iraqi oil pipelines have led to a dramatic reduction of oil coming from the Persian Gulf and has impacted on world oil markets. But officials say the pipelines should be back online within several days. In Washington, Afghanistan's President Hamid Karzai talked to members of Congress today, thanking America for helping to liberate his country from terror and oppression, as he put it, but that a long road lies ahead. Tomorrow begins the last 2 days of hearings by the 9/11 Commission. Tomorrow, the commission staff will release a report that says Al-Qaeda originally planned the attacks for May or June of 2001, but had to delay the attack until September 11th because the hijackers weren't ready. Thursday, the final hearing will explore why military jet fighters from NORAD were not dispatched in time to perhaps shoot down some of the hijacked planes. Authorities have conceded that the fighter jets did not get in the air as quickly as they should have. Police in Wildwood, New Jersey, continue to probe the apparent murder of an elderly man. 81-year-old Wallace Savitz was found dead inside his sixth-floor apartment in the Sandman Towers. An employee found him dead after he failed to make his daily call to the front desk. Police have not said how Savitz was killed or if they are close to finding a suspect. 21-year-old Miguel Serrano is facing murder charges in the death of Pennsauken businessman Tong Nguyen. Prosecutors say Serrano conspired with others to rob the victim. After Nguyen left the check-cashing agency that he ran in Philadelphia, Nguyen's body was found tied with duct tape last week in Camden. Police say more arrests are possible. It was a security scare today at Philadelphia International Airport. Officials evacuated Terminal A and forced 2,500 passengers to be rescreened after three teenage girls looking for their flight to Cancun were mistakenly escorted into a secure area by an airline worker. The girls were detained for questioning before they were released. During the resulting search of the airport, a passenger came across a starter's pistol in a bathroom. Officials say they are trying to figure out how someone got that past a security checkpoint. Still to come on Action News tonight, pop star Britney Spears pulls the plug on her summer concert tour and why doctors in one hospital are performing a medical exam on a mummy. Cecily Tynan returns with a five-day from AccuWeather. Gary Papa with the Phillies pitcher struggling against Detroit tonight when Action News continues.
Some cars are just natural-born followers. But this car has a different vibe. It's all about go and do. 16-valve power, road-tuned suspension. Just go where the vibe takes you. The 2004 Vibe, the new power Pontiac.
The Pontiac Vibe gets great gas mileage. And now non-GM owners and lessees lease a Vibe for around $199 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for details. See your local Pontiac dealer today.
You okay?
My dial-up service makes me sluggish.
Verizon Business DSL could pep you right up.
Oh, yeah?
You can download big files faster, access email from almost anywhere.
Sounds pricey.
It's less than you think.
Give your business the speed and value of Verizon Business DSL. Call 1-866-YES-2-DSL now for a special offer.
So, what do you think?
Verizon Business DSL is just what the doctor ordered.
Verizon.
New Jersey drivers, somebody's been getting a free ride at your expense. Auto insurance fraud criminals. They've been a costly burden on good drivers. Well, their party's over. New Jersey's tough new auto insurance laws are working. Insurance companies have more competition, so you have more choices. Rates are down for over a million drivers, and prosecutions are up 50%. So the criminals who commit fraud are getting another ride, straight to jail. Insurance fraud hurts everyone. We're not tolerating it, and neither should you.
It's ant season. Terminix them with our exclusive problem-solved guarantee. 1-800-TERMINIX. It's roach season. Terminix them with our exclusive problem-solved guarantee. 1-800-TERMINIX.
I want to try one of the new premium salads from McDonald's. But which one? The fruit and walnut salad with apples, grapes, and walnuts? Or the fiesta salad? Warm taco, meat, cheese, and tortilla strips. Mmm, decisions, decisions. I'm loving it. Oh.
Open 6 a.m. or earlier till midnight or later.
If you see news happening, call the Action News tip line toll-free at 866-NEWS-6 or contact us online at WPVI.com.
Politics Now, Democratic presidential candidate John Kerry delivered the keynote speech at the New Jersey AFL-CIO convention in Atlantic City today. The group used the forum to endorse Kerry for president. The Democratic hopeful talked about minimum wages, jobs, and productivity. Before he left, he took a walk on the boards and shook hands with a number of tourists, translation, potential voters. Camden City Council took up the controversial Kramer Hill redevelopment project for the first time tonight. At issue is a billion-dollar plan to build thousands of new homes and shops. Protesters hit the streets with their anger and held signs at tonight's meeting. Opponents say the plan will force hundreds of Kramer Hill residents to move. Despite the opposition, council took the next step in the process. Lawmakers voted to hold a second hearing on the proposal on June 30th. A man featured in a recent Crime Fighters report is awaiting extradition to Camden County tonight on attempted murder, kidnapping, and other related charges. 21-year-old Darryl Dwayne Townsend was arrested in the Northern Liberty section of Philadelphia over the weekend in a car that was reported stolen from Pensauken. He is accused of several domestic assaults against his former girlfriend in Camden County, including a January 9th incident where he allegedly shot the 18-year-old woman twice.
And I was asking him, please don't do it. And then he had shot me in my left arm. And then I heard the gun make some type of noise. And then he had shot me again. And that's when I had got shot behind my ear. And I had laid my head down on a step. And I was, like, playing dead.
Well, the act of playing dead probably saved her life. It is not clear when Townsend will return to Camden County to face all the charges. Police in Washington State are hunting for a brazen bandit, one preying on drive-through restaurants. This surveillance video shows it. He not only goes up to, but through the drive-up window. The robber also pulls out phone lines to prevent workers from calling for help. Detectives say they're worried. They say the bandit is getting bolder and more threatening with each stop. The government doesn't think a national Do Not Spam registry will work. The Federal Trade Commission says a list like that could make the spam problem worse. They say senders of unwanted sales pitches might use the registry to get names, not avoid them. The commission was obligated to consider the proposal under the canned spam legislation the president signed in December. The idea was patterned after the successful Do Not Call registry to limit telemarketing calls. The anti-spam summit to discuss other ideas is scheduled for later this year. Britney Spears fans won't get to see her on tour this summer. A severe knee injury forced the singer to cancel her 36-city Onyx Hotel tour, including an